all the way back to the original Dream Game in 1983. Jim Master played a key role in that contest.
We played well, and I especially played well, and that was gratifying to hit the last shot to send it into overtime. But really, it's bittersweet because when I think about that game, not only was it against Louisville, the first time we played them in so many years, but also a trip to go to the Final Four. So I'm glad I played well. I'm glad our team played well for 40 minutes, but not to get to the Final Four really hurt. Well, I think obviously we're playing on emotion the first part of the game. Derek Hoard, who had had a bad season up to that point, a bad half of the year in his senior year, hit three jump shots, if I remember, in the first 10 or 12 minutes of the game that gave us a big boost. Turpin played well for 40 minutes. He got tired in the overtime. I think that was a big factor. And I had a good game, too, and I think that kind of threw maybe Denny Crum and Louisville's game plan off a little bit, that I hit some of my outside shots and just kept us close. You know, basketball sometimes is a simple game. You just need to make a few more shots than the other team. I think we were doing that early. Well, I've thought back to Dirk's layup for ever since that ball game, and it just brings back some memories and bad ones at that. Dirk's such a great athlete, a great player. Went off the wrong foot, I can remember it. I'm the guy that passed him the basketball, and I always remember that play. It developed. It was something that only took a few seconds, but in my mind I could see it like it was slow motion. I threw the ball to Dirk. When he broke from the basket, I said, hey, we're going to win the game, because there was 20 seconds left in the ball game, and I knew at that point if he went to the basket, he was going to make it. There was no doubt in my mind. When he missed the shot again, they came down and made the shot, and then that allowed me to hit my jump shot to send it into overtime. But that's always a play and one moment in my career that I would love to have back. I really felt good about it, because again, there wasn't any pressure on me. I was shooting it well the whole game, and you kind of feel from that distance, after you get by a guy and you're floating towards the basket, you can kind of feel like, hey, this one's, it's on the mark. And of course, then after that, it wasn't too nice of an overtime for us. Melvin Turpin at that time was completely shot. He was probably, as he usually was at UK, overweight. And I think he was just drained from the 40 minutes, because it was a great basketball game, up and down the court, very intense, a lot of defense. I think that took a lot out of him, and when we didn't have him inside to combat against Rodney and Scooter McRae, Charlie Jones, I think that really took a lot out of us. And then obviously they put on that press against us, and which I mentioned earlier, it's really tough to handle their press when you're not used to it.
Most memorable game you've ever played in?
Oh, without a doubt.
It may have been a losing effort, but that game was still one of the best in recent memory. Now let's hear from some of the Wildcats and what they expect from the Cardinals in tomorrow afternoon's game.
You know, you can't get in the game and say, well, they got a lot of players, they're playing a lot of players. You can't, you know, get down. I look forward to playing against them. You know, they got a good team, but I think it's, you know, some teams in the SEC that's, you know, just as good as Louisville.
It's obvious that Louisville outmans us, they out-talent us, but I truly believe that if we go out there and we give 100% and give a good effort like we did tonight, that no matter what the outcome of the game is, we can come away feeling good about ourselves. So, you know, that's the way we're going to look at it, and we're looking forward to it and coming back here in Freedom Hall.
It's one of the biggest games in college basketball to be able to play in it. It's going to be exciting. And for our team, you know, we can kind of relax because we're going to be the underdog, and we can afford to be a little bit loose. The pressure's going to be on them to come out and beat us. And, you know, last year we were supposed to kill them. They took a last second shot the year before. They were supposed to kill us, and they won by 34. So we'll see what happens.
I remember. You all got to remember. My freshman year, every paper you pick up, they don't have a chance. They don't have a chance. Next thing you know, we beat them by 36. So, you know, we have a chance. All the other guys on our team think we have a chance. But they got a great team. We not underestimate them, but we're not going to lay down and die.
Coming up, we'll check the matchups for tomorrow afternoon's game in just a minute.
It's the right color. It's the world's greatest basketball machine, the Wildcat Wagon. And you can win it free from Golden Flakes Snack Foods, 84 WHAS, Cook & Reeves Superior Vans, and WIMT TV 57. To win, go by any place Golden Flake Stacks are sold or Superior Vans in Louisville and fill out your entry form. Then listen to 84 WHAS and watch TV 57. One of you will win this beautiful van, and you know what I always say?
One taste, suck on Golden Flake.
Hey, what do you say there, buddy? It's me, AJ. And I asked my buddy Max to hook up Buster Swine Song to the Mind Pro to find out what kind of thoughts were rolling around the head of a state champion hog caller. You ready, Buster?
Yeah.
Okay, Max.
Hot dogs.
2.99 cents at Quick Mart.
Gasoline.
Quick Mart.
Groceries.
Quick Mart.
There's a feeling in the mountains, something special's in the air. There's a feeling in my heart I don't get just anywhere. This is a place I love and I'm happy where I am. 'Cause we're just like a family.
One of the youngest teams in Kentucky basketball history. Conversely, it's one of the deepest squads that the Cardinals have ever had. Denny Crum can go 10 deep with his ball club. Right now, let's check the matchups. We begin with overall experience. U of L will start two seniors, two juniors, and a sophomore, all averaging in double figures. Kentucky's lineup consists of three sophomores and a freshman. Junior guard Derek Miller, the only upperclassman, and until this year, his playing time has been limited. The Cardinals are the wealthy team when it comes to experience. At center, Louisville starts 6'9", Purvis Ellison, averaging almost 16 points and 8 rebounds a game. Ellison is hitting better than 65% from the field, and his performance at the defensive end has been equally impressive. Later this season, he should break the Metro Conference record for blocked shots. The defensive side is where Kentucky's Laron Ellis has been lacking. Eddie Sutton was pleased to see a renewed effort against Austin Peay. Ellis leads the Cats in scoring with an average of 20 per game, but he should have his hands full with Purvis Ellison this weekend. In the backcourt, the Cards go with LaBradford Smith and Keith Williams. Smith, a creative guard who can make things happen, is second on the team in scoring and averaging 6.5 assists. Williams missed the first semester with academic problems, but he finished last season as one of the better guards in the Metro and has returned now to give U of L a lift. The Cats counter with a duo of Sean Sutton and Derek Miller. Sutton gives Kentucky an excellent passer who has committed only 25 turnovers, but he's no scoring threat. Miller scored 36 in a game in the Great Alaska Shootout, but since then he's had a difficult time finding double figures. In the backcourt, once again the edge has to go to Louisville. At forward, Louisville goes with veterans Kenny Payne and Tony Kimbrough. Both are double-figure scorers who can contribute in many, many ways. Payne is the major outside scoring threat, hitting 48% from three-point range. Kentucky's Chris Mills is one of the outstanding freshmen in the nation, and he's given the Cats an all-around effort, leading the team in rebounding and putting together a triple-double against Austin Peay. Sophomore Reggie Hansen got off to a hot start. Lately, he's been struggling through a shooting slump. Overall, Louisville again gets the nod. As for the coaches, they are without question two of the best in the game. The Cats' Eddie Sutton is the sixth winningest active coach in America, and he's enjoyed great success in matchups with Denny Crum, both at Kentucky and at Arkansas. Crum has accomplished more in the 80s than any other coach in college basketball, having won two national titles. With both carrying impressive resumes, this category's a standoff. And finally, off the bench, Louisville has been getting outstanding play from a vastly improved Feldon Spencer. The man who's given Kentucky the biggest lift, freshman Richie Farmer with his outside shooting. But U of L's freshman trio of Everick Sullivan, Cornelius Holden, and Boo Brewer has averaged over 18 points and 6 rebounds a game. The Cards' bench support has been the best. Eddie Sutton's teams have won three straight from the Cardinals, but this team appears to be an overwhelming underdog against a powerful Louisville club.
When you play the University of Louisville, their defense is a little different from what most people play that play man defense. They do a lot of switching. Sometimes you almost have to attack it like you're playing a zone. It's a very effective defense, and he's had great success with it. It's something that we really haven't worked on, and so in the next couple of days, we'll try to work on it as much as we possibly can. Their defense bothers me, but their offense bothers me even more because of the people they have on the floor. They're very talented. I know they're not ranked number one in the country right now because they got upset in a couple of early season ball games, but the times that I've seen them play, I think they're just a terrific basketball team and certainly one of the five or six best basketball teams in the country. So it'll take a great effort on our part, both at the offensive end and at the defensive end, in order to win. We will have to play almost a perfect game in order to beat Louisville. Louisville is a much better team than we are if we were to play a series, but that's what makes basketball a great game. You know, I don't think too many people from Bowling Green or Northwest Louisiana thought they could have come into Rupp Arena and beat us, and yet they did. So we're certainly going to give it a 100% effort Saturday afternoon, but we're going to have to play better than we have played and perhaps as well as we're capable of playing in order to win.
Coming up next, Denny Crum talks about his team, and Jack Sutherland and Joe Hall bury the hatchet.
Get the savings. Save over $1,800 on a power-ready Beretta or nearly $1,000 on a sports-minded Cavalier. Command the road with Grand Wagoneer style and pocket over $5,500. Or drive away in a new Corsica with a $2,000 bonus. Just visit Conrad Chevrolet's overstocked lot, make an offer, and we'll make it even better. Conrad Chevrolet, 2800 Richmond Road.
Have you ever been upset by a notice from your bank? It says you're overdrawn or past due, or maybe you don't understand quite what it says. And even more upsetting is the bank's indifference when you ask for help. Take it from Kaywood. You deserve better than that. And that's why at First Commonwealth, we work so hard to help solve your problems and answer your questions in a fast, friendly way. A way that leaves you feeling good about yourself and about us. We treat you like you like to be treated at First Commonwealth Bank.
Hello, friends. This is Melvin Goins at F.S. Vandu's Lumber Company, Paintsville, Kentucky, serving you since 1910 with the best in building material. We specialize in Douglas fir lumber direct from the West Coast, shipped by rail. Much stronger, less likely to warp or rot. Buy and build today and throw those rent receipts away. Two locations, West Prestonburg and Paintsville, Kentucky. So come on down and save, 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 and let's everybody make the competition squeal.
Our philosophy at Mountain Air Respiratory Equipment is when it comes right down to it, the most important commodity in the world is people. Whether you live conveniently in town or off the beaten path, when you need medical equipment, we can deliver. We bring more than medical equipment into your home, we bring caring. Call us at Mountain Air at 1-800-554-7233. That's 1-800-554-7233.
You could call him the coach of the 80s. Louisville's Denny Crum has coached the Cardinals to a pair of national titles and four trips to the Final Four in the last 8 years. He's successful because he's taken nothing for granted. The Louisville Cardinals of December are playing a lot like the U of L teams of March, clicking on all cylinders, offensively and defensively. It's a far cry from 2 years ago in Freedom Hall when Kentucky routed the Cards 86-51. Some expect the same lopsided score this season, but this time in Louisville's favor.
Well, I can assure you there won't be any 30 or 35-point games either way in this game. I those kind of things, I mean, they happen on occasion, but I've never seen, you just rarely see that happen in a game like this.
Crum says the Kentucky-Louisville rivalry is one of the best around, just like it was 5 years ago when the two teams started playing. It's probably no longer a dream game, but Crum says the series has progressed the way he figured.
The good part about it, I think, is that there's no, I don't feel the same animosity and hatred and stuff amongst the fans. You know, we know Kentucky's always going to have good teams and good programs. I think they feel the same about us, and the games are going to be competitive, and it's good, you know, it's good for basketball.
And the question in everyone's mind these days, if the NCAA places UK on probation, will the in-state series continue?
I certainly wouldn't be able to make that decision, nor would I want to. I'm hopeful that we can keep playing Kentucky, just like we play Eastern and Western and Murray and all the other schools in the state. I think it's important that we do that. I think it creates a lot of interest in basketball. And anything that's good for basketball has got to be good for all the teams in the state, which can help be helpful and beneficial to all of us.
One of the biggest Denny Crum fans on this planet is former Lafayette High School coach Jock Sutherland, now the color commentator on the U of L radio network. His popularity in Louisville mushroomed when he began to rep former Kentucky coach Joe B. Hall. But now Jock has backed away from those comments. He talked about it with Dave Baker.
In 1978, Jock Sutherland realized a lifelong dream by leading Lafayette High to the boys' Sweet 16 title. Shortly thereafter, Jock got out of coaching and began a second career as a broadcaster and analyst. Almost immediately, he incurred the wrath of UK fans everywhere by attacking the program and coach Joe B. Hall.
It came about because Dirk was at UK, and he was really, it wasn't working out for Dirk like I wanted it to, and I kind of rebelled in behalf of Dirk, and I spoke up. So in speaking up, I spoke up about Joe B., you know, and the style of the game they had and the way Dirk was being used. So I was really kind of striking out for my main man, Dirk, because I love Dirk Manningfield, and he had done so much for me.
Even though Jock never questioned Hall's integrity or attacked him personally, you can imagine that the relationship between the two became icy at best. It remained that way until a meeting just over a month ago.
We were at Vanderbilt, and Joe was there to speak, really, and the next morning, and he had come over to the Memorial Coliseum where Vandy plays, and he was going to just take a look at Louisville because he was doing the game in the Big Four Classic. And I went by, I saw Joe, and I said, Joe, I'm glad to see you looking good and feeling good. And I just kept walking because I didn't want to get in his face. If I was him, I would hate me, you know. And I walked up and sat in the bleachers, and wasn't just a short time later, Joe walked up and sat down.
I think you got an opportunity.
Strong man. And that was another evidence of strength on Joe's part. Here's a guy like me that said all this stuff about him. Never about his character or anything, only about the coaching ability in the 80s. But Joe was a big enough person. He didn't let that bother me. He just came up and we were old friends again. And I don't expect to be invited to his summer barbecue, you know. But I feel much better about myself now that I've kind of cleared that up with Joe, because I've always felt guilty about saying it. When I say it, I shouldn't have said it. I don't want to ever say anything bad about Joe again, never in my life, because I'll never ever say another negative thing about him.
The Wildcats own 5 national basketball titles, the Cardinals 2. But as Dick Gabriel tells us, the kids on the sidelines who cheer them on have done pretty well in national competition themselves.
At halftime of last week's Louisville Eastern Kentucky game, the Cardinal cheerleaders introduced the routine they hope will win them a 3rd National Cheerleading Association championship. This Saturday, they'll be across the floor from the defending Universal Cheerleading Championship squad from the University of Kentucky.
Competitive because they're in a different division cheerleading. They're NCAA and we're UCA. So, you know, we like to watch each other, but then again, there's not that much competition. We kind of boost each other.
We have great respect for the UK cheerleaders. They're a really good squad, and they've won national championships, and we have as well, and we hope to you know, just have a common bond and be the best cheerleaders of Kentucky.
Organizations are different, with the Universal group encompassing more collegiate squads than the National Association, and their styles are different as well.
Their style is, it's a little bit faster, more upbeat, while ours is kind of a more traditional cheerleading, slow, not as really contemporary maybe as ours is traditional.
I think their stunts are excellent. I really love their routine. It was very creative.
So unlike the basketball teams, these two cheerleading squads never really compete head-to-head, although each has something to prove to each other.
It makes you try a little bit harder because you're proven, we have a name to hold, we're national champions, we have to prove what we are, and they have to do the same.
Coming up, a guy who played in the original Dream Game will tell us how tomorrow's contest will turn out.
From the beginning, there have been special places in Kentucky. Nature at its finest, untouched beauty sparkling in every season. Discover these special places this winter. Experience the magic of Kentucky at a Kentucky state park.
Kentucky parks, Kentucky pleasure.
There's a feeling in the mountains, something special's in the air. There's a feeling in my heart, I don't get just family. Everybody's coming home.
We're a mountain family.
We're a family, yeah.
We're so proud to be. People caring for each other. Make us feel like
sisters and brothers.
Sharing a good time side by side. Continue to be our family pride.
Tell me what we do. We're a mountain family.
Word is out. Mr. Guarantee is working at Hayes Chevrolet Buick and Jackson. But who is he?
I am.
We are!
They all are. And I feel Hayes am the guarantee they'll save you money. I'll challenge any Mountaineer to shop the Lexington dealers and give us last chance to better the deal. In the rare event we can't, we'll buy the gas back to get their car. And oh, by the way, we're not planning on buying much gas.
All roads lead to Jackson, making Hayes Chevrolet Buick the best place to trade. Guaranteed.
For so long, Louisville fans put up with put-downs from Kentucky diehards. Now the Wildcat program is struggling. John Jury recently asked some Cardinal fans about the ongoing saga in Lexington.
The cheering you hear out of U of L fans is not all for Cardinal buckets. Some of it is directed toward Lexington, where their arch rivals are on the NCAA front burner.
You get what you deserve. You get what you deserve. I mean, you know, they know if they're going to pay players, and players are going to come forward and say they have been paid.
You know, I mean, I live in Kentucky myself, but Lexington, that's somewhere east of Louisville. It really doesn't bother me at all.
But not all U of L fans are comedians.
We don't hate them. I don't. I love to play them. I love to beat them. They're about number three on my list.
Well, I think that it's tough on the boys to be out there and playing that way. I'm kind of disappointed in the UK fans that I heard them booing in a game back there.
Sympathy is not one of the feelings U of L fans have for Kentucky right now. In fact, if the Cats are found guilty, most of these folks want the NCAA to drop the hammer on Kentucky.
Pretty hard, I think. They've been having their way a long time, and they just can't get away with it forever. I think that's the way it looks to me.
U of L fans are really loving this, aren't they?
Yes. No, not really. It isn't good for basketball. No, I really hated to see it. I mean, I'm a real diehard U of L fan, but I'm also from Kentucky.
Is the NCAA a little bit too tough on colleges?
No, I don't think so. You know, to a certain extent, yeah, some cases, but I guess that's the way it's got to be to keep everybody clean. You know, everybody's been cheating.
I wish them a lot of luck. I hope it all works out for all of us. But we're going to beat them.
For years, sports writers nationwide all but demanded a UK-U of L matchup. None more loudly than the sports staff of the Louisville Courier-Journal, which back at that time included our own Billy Reed.
Billy Reed was one of those sports writers in the earlier days who was clamoring for a Kentucky-Louisville matchup, and you guys said, Billy, that it won't hurt anybody. It'll be a great game. Do you feel like the game has evolved the way you thought it would?
It really has, Dick. I don't see that any team's lost any fans. I think the basketball has been great. There's been national interest by the part of the networks and the magazines and the newspapers. To this point, it really has evolved into everything I thought it would be. I've even sensed, I think, there's probably more goodwill and good feeling among the fans than there was before. I always felt that by Kentucky taking the attitude of not playing, that was kind of condescending and really engendered more animosity among Louisville fans than what we've seen happen. Now it's just a real good, top-notch college basketball rivalry. I think the one thing that none of us could have anticipated, though, was a situation where Kentucky would all of a sudden be as depleted in the talent department as they are now.
It's been national interest as well. I mean, a lot of interstate rivalries pop up on the regional cable outlets, but this is a national game every year.
That was something that Dr. Singletary and Coach Hall said that wouldn't happen. They just said that only in Kentucky are people interested in that game. But Kentucky and Louisville have been consistently among the top five college basketball programs in the country. And that has been true, that whenever they play, that there is coast-to-coast interest.
When you see these two teams square off in the regular season, do you feel just a touch of vindication that some of the arguments you had made for years are really bearing out?
Well, I think all of us like to be right. I mean, had there been something really ugly, had there been something ugly involving some of the players or the fans, I would have felt very bad about that. But really, it has worked out kind of the way that I'd hoped it would, and I feel good about that. And I'm just glad that that we're able to display to the nation the caliber of basketball that we've been able to produce in Kentucky for a long period of time.
You'd have to be awfully sure of yourself to pick the Wildcats in this one. Jim Master prides himself on his basketball insight, so we asked him to break this one down for us.
It should be. I'll put pressure on Louisville right away. It should be a blowout. Chris Mills, though, is playing better for UK. I think he's the big key. He needs to play a lot of big guard to make some defensive problems for Louisville, and they will have to slow the basketball down. I mean, UK. Against Duke, they did an excellent job. When LaRon Ellis fouled out with 16 minutes to, or got his fourth foul with 16 minutes to go, that kind of hurt him. If he can stay in the basketball game, I think you'll see a slow down tempo. UK will spread it out, make those great U of L players play a lot of defense. I think it'll be closer than people think, but again, we shouldn't stay close with them, but I think it'll be closer than people think.
Well, the time for talking is now over, and it's up to the teams to make things happen. It all gets underway at 4:00 tomorrow afternoon. For the rest of our 27 Sports First team, I'm Rob Bromley.
Battle for the Bluegrass, UK versus U of L, with your 27 Sports First team, is brought to you in part by Ashland Oil. We believe in the value of teachers because teachers change lives. Valvoline High Performance Motor Oil. Valvoline, because motor oil is not just motor oil. Kroger, our service is priceless. And by GTE, the source for your telecommunication needs.
Mountain Ford's final sale of 1988 begins Tuesday, December 27th. For 5 days, we'll be trying our best to top every sale of the year. If you're in the market for a new car or truck, be sure you don't miss this sale. We have an excellent selection of all models, including four-wheel drives. And we refuse to be undersold. You just can't beat a Mountain Ford deal, and we prove it every day. Mountain Ford, Lincoln Mercury, Daniel Boone Parkway, Hazard, Kentucky.
This week's Long John Silver's WYMT Mountain High School Basketball Player of the Week is Paintsville's Jerry Pelfrey. The 6'6" senior forward had 31 points against Johnson Central, 17 rebounds and 8 assists as they won 58-50. Versus Laurel County, he had 31 points, 14 rebounds and 8 assists as they lost. But versus Hopkinsville, he had 27 points and 14 rebounds and 3 more assists as they won 63-61. Congratulations to Jerry Pelfrey of Paintsville High School, our Long John Silver.
They can go as far as they want to go. They're playing with emotion. That's the key. They're young. They're aggressive. They've lost two. They feel like they've given up two Super Bowls, and this is one they cannot let get away. They want it very badly.
All right, the Bears win it 20-12 in the fog, and in the fog, we go back down to Brent Musburger.
Under the circumstances, too. Nice job upstairs, gentlemen. Neil Anderson's with Irv Cross. Let's go to Irv.
Okay. Neil, of course, you came in the game with banged up with some groin injuries and some hamstring injuries, but did it bother you or not?
Not really. It bothered me a little bit in the beginning, but I missed last year's playoff game with an injury, and I had to play in this one because if we didn't win this one, there's no tomorrow.
Did the fog affect your vision?
Well, it did somewhat, but fortunately for us, we got out to an early lead, and we were able to sit on it, but the fog was a factor.
Congratulations.
Okay,
you.
Thank
Brett?
You.
All right, Irv, thank you very much. Dick, your perspective on this victory this afternoon by Chicago?
Well, I think it they did a good job because as you look at the Eagles side, whatever was said at halftime, they came out, they didn't roll over. You know, Cunningham is still a great quarterback. Byers, Keith Jackson had a big game. So, you know, they hung in there all the way to the end. I know we make mention of the fact of the fog and everything else, but I tell you what, the game wasn't over until the last few minutes, so they did a pretty good job.
Yeah, you bet, Dick. A young team, and they'll be back stronger than ever next year. And a reminder that coming up next on CBS, we'll take you indoors. No fog expected for this one, folks. Kentucky-Louisville. And then tomorrow, Minnesota and San Francisco, 3:30 Eastern Time. So for Dick Butkus, Irv Cross, Will McDonough, Terry Bradshaw, and Vern Lundquist, I'm Brent Musburger. So long from Chicago.
The NFL Today postgame show has been sponsored by Miller Lite, official sponsor of the Miller Lite NFL Lineman of the Year Award. Why is video whiz Kevin Keegan driving the school board bonkers and the students wild?
Cue them.
Could it be TV 101 Special Time Special Night Monday?
This is CBS.
The mountains of eastern Kentucky, symbolic of the region's strength and beauty. Another symbol of the region, a mountain logo of Morehead State University. We're proud of our mountain heritage. We're proud of our tradition of offering affordable quality education to the people of eastern Kentucky. And like these beautiful mountains, MSU will always be here to serve you. We're proud to be called Morehead State, University of the Mountains.
The staff at Cumberland Ford Motors in Middlesboro would like to take this opportunity to thank the fine people of Middlesboro, Bell County, and the tri-state area for their support during a time when they most needed it. Their building may have been destroyed, but not their business. The new sales location is the old Clancy's building across from their previous lot, and the Parts and Service Department is located at the North 18th Street Extension. Look for us to be back bigger and better than ever in the months to come, and thanks again from Cumberland Ford Motors.
If you own one of these foreign or domestic cars, then Mountain Repair is for you. With our Allen Test computer analyst system, we can locate the problem in your cranking, charging, primary and secondary ignition, timing, cylinder, and fuel systems, giving you better driving performance. Don't let your car's fuel injection put you in a bind. Mountain Repair has the equipment and expertise to put you back in the driver's seat. Call day or night for your foreign or domestic car service. That's Mountain Repair in the Darfork section of Hazard.
Hee-haw, Saturdays at 7 on WYMT.
We're in historic Freedom Hall, located in the massive Kentucky Fair and Exposition Center. It's sold out for today's game between two down-home rivals, the Kentucky Wildcats and the Louisville Cardinals. 17-29 remaining in the first half. Surprisingly, Kentucky, the heavy underdog here, jumped out to a 5-0 lead. Sean Sutton with a three-pointer, Ellis with a tip. It was 5-0, and right now it's 5-3 Kentucky. Tim Brandt and Billy Packer with you.
Tim, what we have right away is Kentucky not going into any kind of delay game. They're playing in an open offense, but they are looking for the shot. They've come out here very confident in the way they're stroking it.
Miller for three. He's the leading three-point shooter for Kentucky. Was 7 of 8 against Cal earlier this year.
Kentucky playing back in the zone. So far, they've been able to do a good job, except when Kenny Payne goes outside.
Louisville has won 6 games in a row coming in today. And many people here, Billy Packer, are talking about them possibly as national champions. And, of course, Kentucky, the heavy underdog.
I believe this is could be the finest Louisville team that Denny Crum has ever had. It really combines everything. It's got power. It's got strength. It's got good shooting ability and quickness.
Inside, Hansen is fouled by Purvis Ellison. That'll be his first. The team first.
Foul is on Ellison, number 42.
A lineup. Reggie Hansen starts in the front court along with Chris Mills, the freshman. And Ellis is the center. Sean Sutton, the coach's son, in the backcourt along with Derek Miller, who just hit that three-point shot. Reggie Hansen is a 77% free throw shooter, and he hits the first one. He's UK's best defensive player.
Well, Tim, as Eddie Sutton told us this morning, this may be the biggest situation he's ever been in terms of being an underdog. You figure Louisville, a superior team in talent, much more experience, playing in their home court. Kentucky only gets 150 tickets to this game. And then the revenge factor. The last time these two played here, you can remember what Kentucky did to Louisville.
Blew them out. It's 10-3, Kentucky.
There's that 2-3 zone.
Kimbrough for three.
And in that ball game that we remember 2 years ago, Louisville hit 1 3-point shot that was really a weakness in their club that year. Kentucky that day made 11 of them for 33 points, so a big differential. But now this Louisville team, very good from the three-point area.
All of the Cardinals' points thus far have come from that area. Beyond the arc, it's 10-6. Sean Sutton inside the Laron Ellis, and he is the key today. He's got to be strong. Fight for the rebound inside. And Mills is fouled. A starting talent for Louisville. Tony Kimbrough, versatile swingman. Kenny Payne, Louisville's top three-point shooter. Ellison had 24 blocks in the last four games. All-American. The backcourt, Keith Williams, is back after sitting out first semester. His third game back. And LeBradford Smith, a super sophomore. He leads the team in assists.
Right here is a young man that is blossoming as one of the best freshmen, and he was expected to be when he came to Kentucky, but he's one of the best freshmen in the country. Averaging over a dozen rebounds a game in the last five games, he has the total package. He can rebound, he can shoot well, he defends well, he's got good size, can play multiple positions.
He's only a 55% free throw shooter this year, though, and he hits that one.
That'll improve when you see that stroke.
The lead is six by Kentucky. Just under 16 minutes to play in the first half.
There's that lob. Good idea to go right over the top of the zone.
It's for three. LeBradford Smith for three.
This may be Cal State Riverside Iowa game all over again.
Hansen takes it across for Kentucky, and he's double-teamed there. Tries to break the trap, ball's loose. Mills gets it back. For three.
Now, it's very difficult if you're going to trap on that weak side, if you can get the ball across, particularly Derek Miller, who is developing into a great outside shooter, was as a freshman, slumped last year, but coming back well now. No place to go.
For 3 points, Kimbrough. Lead has been cut to three.
Kentucky doing a great job handling the press. There you see them going cross court against that double team.
That foul is on Williams. That's his first. Third team foul. A look at Denny Crum in his 18th year. 75% winning percentage. This may be his best team yet. Timeout on the floor. It's 15-12 Kentucky.
Oh, Harold. It's lovely.
I hope you like it.
It reminds me of when he first got electric light back when I was a child.
Oh.
Daddy used to draw his chair up to that light and read to us.
Mm.
Oh, and memories. But Harold, this is the 80s. Mm-hmm. And I wanted a Bud Light.
If you want the one light that outshines them all, ask for Bud Light.
Kill the light, will you, Harold?
Ooh, because everything else is just a light.
You seen those Chevy versus Ford tests, right? We came up with one of our own. Half-ton 4x4s, best available tires, driven at the same identical speed right through this 18-inch deep ditch. Now, this is a real controlled test, so don't you try it, because you'll damage your truck. That's the Chevy with torsion bar suspension, and that's the Ford with twin traction beam suspension. And you can see why we've had a change of hardened pickups.
That's today's Chevy truck.
My dandruff shampoo is good.
Maybe you should try something else. My dandruff shampoo really works.
Maybe you should try something else. like Selsun Blue.
Doctors and pharmacists recommend Selsun Blue more than all other leading brands combined.
What that means to you is no leading brand gets rid of dandruff better than Selsun Blue. It's number one.
And all Selsun Blue formulas, including extra conditioning and extra medicated, have the ingredient recommended most by doctors.
CBS Sports coverage of college basketball is sponsored by UPS. We deliver to every address in the U.S. and to 41 countries worldwide. New Michelob Dry from Anheuser-Busch. And by the heartbeat of America, today's Chevrolet.
Kentucky head coach Eddie Sutton in the eye of the storm. His fourth year at Kentucky, his youngest team ever.
Has won 74% of his games throughout his coaching career at three different Division I schools. One of the outstanding teachers in the game. His team doing very well right now. And there's something you don't see often. Louisville forced to go to zone early on.
It's 15-12 Kentucky, 14:50 remaining in the first half. This is Sean Sutton, the coach's son. He's been also in the eye of the storm. People think that Richie Farmer should be starting in front of Sutton. Miller for three.
Great tapping.
The follow by Mills.
I think it's going to be Hanson's. Both went up there and got a piece of it. Yep, you're right, Tim.
They gave it to Mills. It's 17-12, Kentucky.
I think the point there, the three arms from Kentucky were right up in the middle.
Kimbrough had the shot, didn't see it. Out to Williams on the right wing. Zone defense now by the Wildcats.
I think what Louisville ought to try to do is to go right into the high post against this particular defense. Try to throw the ball over Sutton's head to Purvis Ellison.
There's Ellison with the turnaround.
Now that one happened to be on the baseline, but I believe they can get that all day long. And Purvis is such an excellent passer that even when he gets it inside and is guarded, he can hit the free man.
1-3-1 pressure defense now by Louisville. Kentucky breaks it. Sutton will set the offense.
What Louisville does and has done for many years better than anybody in the country is they go from that zone press to man-to-man. Again, another follow-up. This one is by Hanson.
Reggie Hanson with the follow. Keep in mind, Kentucky's at the bottom of the SEC statistics in both scoring and rebounding, but they've been aggressive thus far this afternoon. But it's early. Took Ellison 7 minutes to score, Billy. This is Kimbrough for three.
When you take a look at Louisville shooting these threes, 2 years ago for the whole season, they only made 42 three-point shots. It was a big weakness in their game.
The lead is two. LaRon Ellis is trapped, and he better get rid of it. 5 second call. No, he walks.
If LaRon would have kept that ball down a little low, he almost busted that double team. Now watch, he pulls the ball up high, and by doing this, he doesn't have the strength to bust through the double team. If he keeps the ball low, he'll go right through that double team and not walk.
Let's keep an eye now against his zone on Tony Kimbrough. Kimbrough is 3-for-3, 3-point conversions.
And of course, on the other side, you have Kenny Payne, so it's tough for that defense. They've got it spread way out now, and you notice how open the middle area is. There it is.
Ellison.
It's going to be difficult for Kentucky not to give up something. What they're doing right now is giving up the middle, trying to protect against the threes. Louisville recognizes and hits it well in there.
We're tied. First tie of the game.
Great pass.
Inside to Mills. Correction, Miller.
What I think is shaking up Louisville right now, Tim, is the fact that they expected Kentucky to play a slowdown game.
Smith's shot won't go. Fight for the rebound. Ellison.
So smart. If he put the ball back up on the right-hand side of the rim, that ball would have been blocked again. He moved to the left, used the rim.
Second tie of the game. Kimbrough with the steal. Williams with the bucket. No, it won't go. And the foul is on Reggie Hanson.
Well, Tim, since this series has resumed, I have been at every game. And with the exception of that first one in Knoxville, I think this one has got more attention than any other.
First team foul against Kentucky. We're tied.
American business can save millions of dollars every year with the UPS Next Day Air Letter.
unlike other companies which frequently charge up to $14, UPS, because we're so efficient, charges only $8.50. And we guarantee overnight delivery to every address, coast to coast. The UPS Next Day Air Letter, the super saver of overnight letters.
Rough day.
Sure glad that's over with.
After a day like this, you head for the beer that goes down smooth as a mountain stream.
Bush.
Rough day. Rough day. Your horse did all the work.
Head for the mountains of Bush beer.
Listen to the heartbeat of America.
The fun it gives you, it just could be one of the best bargains you've ever driven.
Ooh, the heartbeat of America.
That's the day, Chevrolet.
They rammed L.A. Now the Vikings are out to topple Mighty Joe and the Niners. An NFC playoff battle tomorrow on CBS Sports.
Took Purvis Ellis 7 minutes to get going, Billy, but he has 3 field goals in the last 2 minutes.
Well, what Purvis does is let the game come to him. Now, he might have been pushing a little bit on the inside here, but goes up strong with two hands. See, he gets it blocked. He's smart enough to go and use the rim to defend against the defenders himself. Great inside play. The only man in the country last year that had over 100 blocks, 100 points, 100 rebounds, and 100 assists.
Kentucky fights for the screen inside to Smith, the whistle in.
You can see how quick LeBradford Smith is. Puts the ball on the floor. He's so strong. Penetrates about as well as anybody in the country.
The foul is on Chris Mills, his first, the team's second.
This zone defense is helping Kentucky stay out of foul trouble, particularly Ellis.
Kenny Payne gets it back to Smith, who set the offense. Kentucky looks to be in a man zone now, matchup zone.
Job by Sutton using that body right up on Smith
inside. Whistle and a foul. Bucket won't go. Everett Sullivan took it right to the hoop.
Now here's a young man, if you have not seen him play yet, is going to develop into one of the nation's best. Everett Sullivan from South Carolina goes right to the hoop. I watched him in pregame practice. He made 8 in a row from the NBA three-point line. Number 2 player in the state voting-wise last year, for the last 2 years behind Stanley Roberts.
The foul was on Hansen. That's his second, the 13th foul against Kentucky. Talking about Sullivan. Sullivan, Holden, and Brewer combined to average 18 points, 6 rebounds, and 5 assists off the bench. It is a strong Louisville bench. That's the first Cardinal lead of the afternoon. It's 22-21 Louisville.
And there's the 2-2-1 full court press. Good job by Sullivan.
Sullivan did lose it out of bounds. It'll be Kentucky basketball.
One of the things Denny Crum will always say, that our offense starts with the defense. And you can see that's been the case in this comeback by Louisville.
Louisville is on an 8-2 run. This is Ellis over to Miller for 3. Won't go. Rebound, Payne.
The Bradford Smith threw it behind Purvis Ellison that time. He had the right idea, just the wrong placement. And you can see how well Purvis runs the floor.
Louisville has averaged 17 turnovers in the last 7 games. The Cardinals had 33 in their loss to Xavier.
Really a smart play by Sean Sutton. He brought the ball up court gradually, anticipated the trap as he crossed the half-court line, and looked one way and passed the other. That's how he got by with that trap.
Foul is on LeBradford Smith. That's his second.
And the game for
15 foul against Louisville.
Keith Williams back in the ballgame. Denny Crum really deep with this club. And as you can remember, a few years ago, he stayed with a 6-man rotation. Now with this club, he can go 9 or 10.
Louisville stays in his zone.
2-3 zone.
LaRon Ellis kicks it back out to Sutton, who's got a shot, now takes it. This is Williams.
Holden, such a good rebounder on the inside, too. Two freshmen in the lineup.
Sullivan holds it high over his head. Now brings it back out front. He's not shy, Sullivan. He averages a shot every 2.5 minutes, and that's off the bench.
See, really extending that defense out there and giving Purvis Ellison a chance to go in behind it.
Kenny Payne for two. And Louisville lead is three. Kentucky wants a timeout with 10:09 remaining in the first half.
Arkansas, UCLA, the Mobile Cotton Bowl, January 2nd.
You're looking sharp. You're looking good. You've come so far. And we know how to make the most of who you are. Father to son. It's what we've always done. Gillette.
The Gillette Atra Plus system with the Lubra Smooth Strip for the best a man can get.
Beautiful. She's just not real friendly sometimes. The days get shorter, the cold makes things kind of brittle, and the boys, well, they just get uglier. But come nightfall, when the fire gets hot, you still get thirsty.
Bush.
Winter's not so bad.
Head for the mountains of Bush Beer.
S10 Blazer, the most powerful V6 engine available in its class, and the most fun available in any class.
The heartbeat of America, Chevrolet.
Today's Chevrolet.
It's a sold-out Freedom Hall in Louisville, where Kentucky, the heavy underdog, came out with a 5-0 run, held that lead until the 11-minute mark of the first half. The Cards now on a 10-2 run, Billy.
And you notice what Eddie Sutton did. He called the timeout, stopping this momentum a little bit for his ball club. He wants to keep this young team in it as long as he possibly can.
It's a three-point Louisville lead.
And Louisville not guarding the man, taking the ball out of bounds, looking for their trapping defense.
Sean Sutton is the ball handler.
Man-to-man.
And actually, once they get it up court, they've been dropping off and letting Sutton take the shots. They don't respect his shooting ability.
They drop back now into his zone.
This is Chris Mills. Gets it back up front to Sutton.
They're not sure what defense they're in right now. Kenny Payne thought they're in his zone.
Reggie Hansen now kicks it back out to Sutton. He'll reset the offense. Derek Miller, you can tell him, he wants that ball. He feels like he's got the hot hand.
Well, what's the problem right now is Kentucky can't figure out the defense.
Mills for two.
Boy, he pulls up and takes that jumper nicely. He's listed at 6'7". He plays a big 6'7". And Kentucky matching up in their zone right now. They haven't played any man-to-man so far in this game, and it's really helped them because they're staying out of foul trouble and also don't have to go to their bench in terms of the weak situation they have there.
Purvis Ellison, cross-court pass to Kenny Payne.
It's nice at 6'10 to be able to pass the ball over the top of zones.
Right now, it's Holden, Sullivan, Williams, Purvis Ellison and Kenny Payne on the court for Louisville.
Deron Ellis doing a good job coming up and meeting guys that are trying to break to the middle.
Sullivan for two. Correction, three.
He has incredible range.
Awfully close to that arc. It was for three. It's a 27-23 Cardinal lead.
Is that the fifth three, Tim?
Yes,
for Louisville. So. There's the double team again.
Steal by Williams. Sullivan. Great pass to Payne.
This kid may be a freshman, but not for long. The state of South Carolina had a great year last year in terms of players in that state. Sullivan showing you how outstanding he is. Had the shot, put it behind his back. Beautifully done. Just a great look here because he knew that Miller had a chance to block that shot. Again, it's important for Kentucky to keep the ball in Sean Sutton's hands. When it goes down to Miller, he has a real difficult time against that trap.
is now 7-for-7 from the free throw line this year. He's got 8 points and goes out. Kimbrough comes back in to replace him for Louisville. Derek Miller kicks it back out front to Sutton, and now Sutton says, hey, let's settle it down.
Let's check the defense. Man-to-man defense now by Louisville.
Biggest Cardinal lead of the afternoon. It's 30-23. 8 minutes and 12 seconds remain in the half.
Given these different looks, they've taken Kentucky out of that great sink they were in offensively at the start of the game.
Kimbrough smacked the ball off the head of Ellis.
Here's the pass. Good teamwork all the way around. That's Sullivan back to Payne, the shot we saw earlier.
That's turnover number 4 for Kentucky. Williams inside to Ellison, and he loses it out of bounds. One thing about Louisville, Billy, they'll turn the ball over, but they force a lot of turnovers as well.
Well, Williams, that's only his second turnover in playing over 50 minutes so far this year. He's been very stingy with that ball.
But the entire team has settled in since he's come back. This is only his third game.
Bad play. The Williams. Pressure really starting to get to Kentucky now.
And Williams is fouled by Sutton. That's his third.
And what's happening right now is the great athleticism of Louisville and their great trapping ability is keeping Kentucky from getting into any semblance of a half-court offense. Ellis having to sit down. Scott's in. That's going to hurt him a little bit. Sutton's going to stay out there even though he's got 3 fouls. Look for Richie Farmer in here shortly.
You saw it's a 16-4 Louisville run. The lead is 7. 7 minutes, 25 seconds remain in the half. The Cardinals are turning up the heat. Purvis Ellison. Fight for the rebound. Kimbrough gets it back to
hands.
Hansen is fouled by Ellison.
Purvis had not touched the ball in a while, and he took a shot that really wasn't there, but showed great hands on that catch.
I'll tell you this. This is as aggressive as I've seen Kentucky this year.
I think they're playing with a lot of confidence, and this is also the deepest and I think the most talented from top to bottom team I've ever seen in Louisville. Felton Spencer comes in the game. Denny Crum has 10 really quality players.
Ellison sits down with 2 personals. Miller, too much dribbling, gets in trouble. At the Scott, ball's loose. Sutton gets it back to Mills. And Kentucky controls it. Miller for 2.
Tim, you win with defense, and this defense by Louisville, although it's early in the year, and everybody knows that they're not a big club early in the year, I can see by mid-season it is going to be a tough team to score against.
Sullivan's shot is not even close. Fight for the rebound. Sullivan gets it back.
Better play, and he can shoot it from there.
Kentucky still in his zone. Scott now really putting the pressure on Spencer. Inside. Foul is going to be on Reggie Hansen.
Nice job by Felton Spencer that time to seal his man off.
At the conclusion of every CBS NCAA broadcast, we will be selecting a Chevrolet Most Valuable Player from each team. Chevrolet donates a $1,000 scholarship to the general scholarship fund of each school to further assist qualified students in all chosen academic fields. Hansen sits down with his 3rd personal foul. Craig Hawley comes in for the Wildcats. Correction, Feldhaus. A good look at Spencer.
Well, you know, when you talk about quality big men in the country, when you take in consideration just 7-footers, Felton Spencer is probably among the top 5 in the nation.
He was a high school All-American, both academically and athletically. And again, the ball's loose, and they'll give it to Kentucky.
Whenever Sean Sutton gives that ball up to Miller, you can just see the Louisville players just loving to get into that trap. They're like piranha going after him. They need to send Miller up court, let somebody else come back to help handle the ball.
Chris Mills gets it across safely for Kentucky. He'll take the shot from there for 2, and the rebound to Kimbrough.
Nettie Sutton's decision maybe to force tempo a little bit early in the game, now coming back to haunt him a little bit because his team will have a hard time pulling things up.
Chris Mills Fans thought he got all ball. Instead, they call his second personal.
The ball is on Mills, number 32, his second.
They're in the bonus situation. It'll be a two-shot foul, but the next foul where it's not a shooting foul, it'll be one and one. Sullivan hits the first. He's a 58% free throw shooter. He was runner-up his junior and senior year as the MVP in South Carolina.
How would you like to room with this guy, Tim? You know what his hobby is? He collects sneakers. They get a little stinky in the closet, wouldn't it?
Richie Farmer comes into the ballgame now, replacing Sutton.
Now, Farmer primarily a scorer, but is going to really have to take over the ball handling duties here.
Feldhaus, Ellis, Scott, Farmer, and Miller now on the floor from Kentucky. Sullivan has 6 points off the bench, and again there's a turnover, and Louisville gets it back.
I really don't know what Eddie Sutton can do. Miller is a real problem for him against this press. But you say somebody has got to catch it and pass it to get it over half court.
It's a 9-point Cardinal lead with 5:35 remaining in the first half.
Go right over the top of Farmer in that zone.
Kenny Payne pulls up for two. Around the rim, fight for the rebound. Miller gets it for Kentucky.
Feldhaus breaking.
Miller, 34-27.
And that's where he needs to be employed, at the end of the pass.
He now has 12 points.
Made 7 out of 7 threes in a game earlier this year, so he can shoot it.
Wildcats stay in his zone. Payne with a little jump hook, and he's fouled by Scott.
I have never seen him in his 4 years take a hook shot. He's primarily a jump shooter, but he came across that lane nicely.
Number 50, his first.
Coming up at halftime, James Brown will bring us up to date on the scores of the day and the news. Curry Kirkpatrick will summarize the problems encompassing and the allegations surrounding the University of Kentucky. And Curry and Billy Packer will give their strong opinions of what should or should not be done with the program in Lexington. Billy Payne is perfect on the year, Billy, at the free throw line.
Well, if you're a young player at home, and Payne is not one of the great scorers in America, but if you're a young player at home and want to watch perfect form with a one-handed shot, I don't know if anybody has any better form than this man right here. Just perfect. And that goes for his jump shot as well.
Payne now has 10 points. It's 36-27. Louisville.
See how Farmer handles the press. He doesn't want to get over that half-court line and pick up his dribble as he did. He's too small for that.
Farmer throws it away. Kimbrough. Back to Brewer. And now they work it around the horn, trying to get it inside. Spencer, offensive foul.
Attempt. Farmer brought the ball up court gradually. And as soon as he got over half court, he did one of the things you cannot do, and that is to pick up his dribble. Then he became a real target for the trap, and he's too small to throw over the trap. See what they've done now? They brought Mills back and let him try to bring it over, and he can throw over a double team, as he did right there.
Mills is 6'7", just a freshman out of Los Angeles, California.
A great young player.
Farmer can shoot. He had 51 points in the state championship game against Ballard. A superstar. He's the shooter. Sutton's the ball handler. This is Feldhaus. Rebound Brewer of Louisville.
No place for LeBradford Smith to go, but just his tremendous athleticism draws the foul.
First thing they'll tell you is that Smith oftentimes out of control, but that's just youth. Bradford Smith, just a sophomore. The foul was on Feldhaus.
You know, I was talking with him yesterday, and I asked him, 2 years ago when Louisville got such a big beating against Kentucky, were you watching the game? He said, no. He said, I was playing against Pittman, a boy who had signed with Kentucky, now playing at Oklahoma State. And he said, when we came out at halftime, everybody starts talking about go, Cats, go, and he didn't realize what had happened. Of course, he ends up here at Louisville. Pittman never does attend Kentucky.
Cornelius Holden comes in and replaces Kimbrough. Kimbrough will go sit down. Smith comes from an athletic family as he prepares for his second shot. His two sisters, Annette and Audrey, played with the University of Texas women's team, won a national championship in 1986. Then there's timeout on the floor. 3:59 remaining in the half.
From now on, this is what dry is. Dry is a beer that starts bold from the first taste, finishes clean with no aftertaste, and refreshes completely. Dry is a beer called Michelob Dry. One taste, and you'll drink it dry.
Sport Coupe, designed to help you look better, engineered to help you drive better, and priced to let you live better.
The heartbeat of America, Chevrolet, Chevrolet.
Anywhere in the world, you can dial direct. You can dial with MCI for up to 22% less than AT&T. At MCI, we don't just promise you the world, we give it to you for less. Until you call, you'll never know how much better a long-distance company can be.
How fast does Dristan nasal spray start to work?
Faster than Dolly can pick up a $5 tip.
Dristan works fast to relieve nasal congestion, even sinus pressure. For relief...
faster than a frog on a hot rock.
Try Dristan nasal spray. It's faster than...
Why is video whiz Kevin Keegan driving the school board bonkers and the students wild?
Cue them.
Could it be TV 101 Special Time Special Night Monday?
Kentucky has been playing a 3-2, a 2-3 zone. You can see that's the back line across there. What happened? Louisville flattened that zone out, creating a big hole right here. And watch what happens as Kenny Payne fills the void. Nobody there to take him. Easy jump shot. Good job by Louisville to recognize what's played against them.
Billy, we just saw a good example of the new timeout rule. They've got to be out at the first whistle with 15 seconds left in that timeout. They tried to get Derek Miller in the ballgame for Kentucky. He was too late. They had to keep Scott in. Now Derek Miller comes into the ballgame. So Scott goes out, so it's Mills, Ellis, Feldhaus, Sutton, and Miller on the floor. Or Feldhaus goes out.
And there's a five-second call on the end line. This year, as you know, the ball, if he had released it, he'd have been all right, but had nobody to pass to, instead just ate the ball.
Kentucky led 19-14 with a slow tempo. Last 10 minutes, Louisville's on a 24-8 run. They've picked things up drastically.
Brewer and Holden again, two freshmen on the floor for Louisville. Felton Spencer wants it. Good
nice
call.
Pass inside, and he's fouled by Scott. Tomorrow on CBS Sports, the NFC playoffs continue as the Minnesota Vikings, with the top-rated defense in the NFC, take on the top-rated offense against the San Francisco 49ers. It all starts with the NFL today at 3:30 Eastern Time.
Timmy, you're a football man, okay? Minnesota struggled during the course of the year. How come they get the most guys on the Pro Bowl team?
I'll tell you what, you'll find coaches throughout most of that season said that Minnesota had the closest thing to a dominating team throughout the season. They had their slump like everybody else. A lazy team.
Leron Ellis a little lazy coming to that pass. Against a pressing team, you better come and meet every pass, even if you think you're open.
3 minutes and 33 seconds remain in the first half.
Mills is really smart. He looked ahead, he saw Miller and said, you know, I don't think I ought to put it up to him at this point in the game.
Louisville has 8 points off eight Kentucky turnovers. Kentucky has no points off turnovers, and it's the biggest Louisville lead of the game, 40-27.
And again, as Denny Crum says, our offense starts with the defense, and they've done that well today. Back in a little zone now, matching up.
They are not even coming out to Sutton. This is Miller. His shot won't go. Fight for the rebound. Brewer has it. He pulls up for the jumper and hits.
Brewer, a great high school football player in addition to being a basketball star. Again, the press is so effective. Kenny Payne doing a great job up front.
9 Kentucky turnovers.
That Brewer runs the 220 and 21-6. Broad jump 23-6. Second on the team is Spud Webb's cousin.
Holds his high school records in both. This is Sutton on the breakaway.
Can't turn back. Good job by Sean Sutton. You know, we ought to talk about the courage that he showed. Yesterday he went down in practice, got hit again in that eye, blood coming out of the eye, not wearing that protective goggles that he had earlier in the year. Tough kid.
Inside pass and an easy bucket for Holden.
Little breakdown in Kentucky zone.
Derek Miller has the shot, now can't find his way back up, gets it to Ellis. Ellis' shot won't drop. Brewer with another rebound for Louisville.
That's a good job by Holden that time, altering the shot.
And the foul.
That's his fourth, I believe, on Sean Sutton. Sutton. Really hurts Kentucky because his ball handling has helped them beat the press.
They called it on Chris Mills.
Well, Sean held his hand up, which was not a smart move on his part. That's Mills' third.
So Brewer goes to the line, shooting 1-1.
And if you're Eddie Sutton, you want this next 2 minutes and 11 seconds to go by in a hurry. His troops are wearing down. They're getting into serious foul trouble. Be smart maybe to go into a little delay game the rest of the way. Try to use up some clock.
Really haven't used a lot of the 45-second clock at all in this ball game. And Brewer fouls Miller.
Undefeated clubs, two from the Big East right there. Seton Hall really off to a great start. Illinois, I saw that club work out in Hawaii. It's just a real sharp club. Rick Majerus, what a comeback by his club at Ball State. Georgetown, we've seen them. We know about them. And Duke, a team that everybody knew would be up there early. So a lot of clubs undefeated. It won't last forever, that's for sure.
Brewer's foul puts him over the limit. Miller's at the line. He'll shoot 1-1. Miller has 12 points today. 6'5 sophomore from Savannah, Georgia, makes the first one. Started the last 7 games. He's not known for his defense or his ball handling, but he can fire from long range outside the 3-point arc.
Well, it was amazing last year. He put himself under such pressure. And again, for young kids playing the game, you've got to have that confidence. He had the stroke. He just couldn't get anything to fall last year. He certainly got that confidence back now.
Sullivan and Kimbrough come back in for Louisville now. Holden goes out.
Well, they're just reloading, Jim. This is really a talented squad.
And Brewer gets a break.
And you know, when Denny Crum first came to Louisville, he had the John Wooden system. You play 6 guys and that's it. Talking to him yesterday, and I admire this in any coach, being flexible to realize he's got a lot more than that in regard to talent, so he's using it.
Kimbrough has to reload midair, still hits for 2. It's 46-31 now, Cardinals. Well, that too could be a factor in this game, Billy, the depth factor. Louisville does have the depth. Kentucky only has 9 players on scholarship. And they're not deep. Miller's shot won't go.
And when you get tired, you lose that touch.
Nice pass. And the foul will be against LaRon Ellis. Coming up on Monday, January 2nd on CBS Sports, 1:30 Eastern Time, it's the Mobile Cotton Bowl as the 8th-ranked Arkansas Razorbacks take on the 9th-ranked UCLA Bruins. This is the 32nd consecutive year CBS has broadcast the Cotton Bowl. That's college football action Monday right here on CBS Sports. That game's in Dallas. Cowboys have the number 1 pick, and the quarterback of UCLA, Troy Aikman.
And Payne continues to fill it up from that foul line.
Payne now has 11 points. Excellent free throw shooter. That's been well documented. He's been in a shooting slump, though. He's 8 for 21 in his last 3 games.
He's still shooting 48% from the 3-point line.
Was voted the most improved player on the team last year. And he hits that one. 48-31 with 1:20 remaining in the half.
Here's the man that's had the problems with ball handling. Miller gets rid of it.
Sutton goes back to the middle.
Reggie Hansen was open, too late getting it to him.
Miller, this one's for 2.
That's the way to fill that hole against the zone. Miller came from the weak side. He's been staying over there just looking for his shot. Good job.
He now has 16 points, Billy. Turned to the bench. He thought that shot was from 3. He didn't know where he was on the court. It was only for 2. Sullivan's shot is short. Ellison can't control it, now does, and kicks it way back out front.
How about LeBradford Smith? He went up as high as he had to get that errant pass.
Nice pass, pass inside to Sullivan.
You can see why LeBradford Smith is leading the Metro with almost 7 assists a game. He really has great eyes.
He has 5 assists today. This is Mills on the right side. Nice pump fake.
Oh, almost through the foul. There he goes again.
Good looking play. They can't convert.
How about Sullivan's pass?
LeBradford Smith goes out. Williams comes back in for Louisville. Sullivan showing something. Smith has handed out 6 or more assists in 5 of the last 6 games. But Sullivan with a fine pass. Under 10 seconds now in the first half.
Well, Tim, Denny Crum has won 2 national championships in the 80s. Been to the Final Four countless times, but in my opinion, this is the best-looking Louisville team I've seen that Denny Crum has had.
That's the end of the first half with the score. Louisville 50, Kentucky 35. CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball will continue after this message and a word from your local station.
This is CBS.
Hey, what do you say there, buddy? It's me, AJ. You know, some years ago, somebody had the bright idea of having UK play Louisville to find out who rules the state in basketball. Now, some folks call it the dream game, but for me, it's become an annual nightmare. My first love are the Cats, but I root for the Cards, too. Of course, then, deep down inside beats a heart of true blue. Well, this year, I'm taking the advice of the folks at Quick Mart, and I'm going to be a Kentucky fan from head to toe. So no matter who wins, Kentucky wins. Go blue or red.
Hi, I'm Holly Robinson of 21 Jump Street. Before I could get the job I have now, I first had to get my act together, study my craft, learn some new skills. When my shot came, I was lucky enough to be ready. If you've got a dream you need to get ready for, you should think about joining Job Corps. At Job Corps, you can get your GED, your driver's license, learn several trades and professions, and get into the union. Job Corps pays you to learn. So get your act together and call Job Corps now.
Night after night after night after night after night.
Welcome back to Freedom Hall here in Louisville, Kentucky. I'm James Brown, and coming your way in just a few seconds on the College Basketball Report, I'll bring you up to date on a very busy day in sports, including the highlights of that NFC playoff game between the Chicago Bears and the Philadelphia Eagles. Curry Kirkpatrick fills us in on the woes of the Kentucky basketball program. I'll have that and more coming your way in just a few moments on the College Basketball Report right after this.
Delivers to every country in Western Europe, the Pacific Rim, Down Under, and Canada. And because we're so efficient, we can deliver your international parcels and documents for fewer francs, yen, or drachmas than other companies charge.
Don't fence me in.
UPS, we run the tightest ship in the shipping business.
The network. It's the most powerful tool in business today. At GTE, we can put that power in your hands. The power of a personalized communications network designed for the success of your business alone. the growth of your business, the prosperity of your business. We've done it for others. We'll do it for you. Because at GTE, the power is on.
4 years ago, I wound up in the hospital after I hurt my Achilles tendon in a basketball game. And I hobbled around on it for a couple of days. The doctor told me I had to go to the hospital, and while I was there, the hospital gave me Tylenol. Worked great for me and got rid of all the pain that I had.
Greg Denton trusts Tylenol, the pain reliever hospitals use most.
I trust Tylenol because it's done the right things for me, and the hospital recommended it, so that makes me feel even better.
Now try new gelatin-coated gel caps, only from Tylenol.
The meek may inherit the earth, but they won't get the ball.
The Force series from Nike.
As you take a look, they do more than dribble basketballs here in Louisville. Of course, this is the home city of the infamous Louisville Slugger, and the Cardinals have a firm grip, leading the Kentucky Wildcats by 15 and a half. And as we swing into the new year, I wish you season's greetings. My name is James Brown, and welcome to the College Basketball Report. Well, without delay, let's get right to the news. In an AFC division battle just up the road in Cincinnati, the Bengals are leading the Seattle Seahawks 21-0, 9 minutes remaining in the second quarter in that game. Meantime, in a game that many of you saw earlier here on CBS, an NFC division playoff game between the Bears and the Eagles, it was Chicago moving to the NFC Championship game by beating the Eagles 20-12. Now, this was the big Eagles matchup. Buddy Ryan returning to Chicago to face his old boss Mike Ditka. No love lost between those two. Well, it didn't take long for Ditka's Bears to strike first in the opening quarter. A 64-yard pass play. Mike Tomczak to Dennis McKinnon. McKinnon outlasts Andre Waters into the end zone, and the Bears take a 7-0 lead. Now, Philadelphia did have its chances today, but blew several scoring opportunities, including this surefire touchdown pass dropped in the end zone by talented rookie Keith Jackson. Then, late in the second quarter, the fog moved onto Soldier Field, hampering play and the camera shots the rest of the way, but play continued despite the fog as the Bears went on to defeat the Eagles by the score of 20-12. So now the Bears move on to the NFC Championship game next Sunday. Their opponent will be the winner of the Minnesota-San Francisco game. That, of course, can be seen right here on CBS tomorrow afternoon, 3:30 Eastern time, and of course it all gets underway with the NFL today. And we'll return to Louisville with more of the College Basketball Report right after this.
A recent Department of Energy study reveals that most American homes are under-insulated. So if you plan to build a house, add on to a house, or just re-insulate, you can find out what's right for your home from you-know-who. Just call Owens Corning at 1-800-GET-PINK.
My son Icky got the Cutlass Supreme SL because it has front wheel drive, FE3 suspension, and because tests prove that the new T-Bird LX and Cougar LS just couldn't run the slalom as fast. That kid, he's got all the moves. This
is not your father, so I learned it from you, Ma. <New generation.
laughs> Here's why these members of the United States Ski Team prefer Alka-Seltzer Plus cold medicine.
I came down with some mean cold symptoms. I was congested, I was tired, I couldn't breathe through my nose. I took Alka-Seltzer Plus and it helped to remove those cold symptoms.
I've got a number of guys that are depending on me, and I have to be out there the next day. And Alka-Seltzer Plus really helps me do that.
Alka-Seltzer Plus cold medicine. Fast, effective relief for tough winter colds. Try Alka-Seltzer Plus nighttime cold medicine to relieve your cold at night. Someday, every international air express company will have it all.
24-hour customer service, advanced tracking systems, and their own fleet of planes flying to Europe, Canada, and Japan, just like Federal Express.
Right.
But until then, the others will just have to pretend.
Nice lightning.
Worldwide service from Federal Express.
Freedom Hall, originally constructed for just one event, the Kentucky State Fair Horse Show, but of course is now the home court of the Louisville Cardinals, as it has been since 1957. Well, when you talk tradition here in Kentucky, of course one of the first topics to come to mind is basketball. Now, no team in history has won more games than the University of Kentucky, and indeed basketball touches just about every aspect of life here in the Bluegrass State. But now the very core of this tradition is crumbling under the weight of a series of NCAA investigations. Curry Kirkpatrick has more on the Kentucky story behind the headlines.
Kentucky basketball under siege is hardly a new development. In fact, it's unlikely even Adolph Rupp has bothered turning over in his grave for all this. The charming old scoundrel was known to bend a rule or two himself. But then is not now. Then had none of the dirt that continues to pile up and threatens to bury Eddie Sutton and the entire Wildcat program. There are 18 NCAA charges. Did assistant coach Dwayne Casey send recruit Chris Mills $1,000 in an air freight envelope?
It tended to put on a lot of pressure when it first happened, when I first heard about it, but, you know, after that, it's just made me a stronger person.
Charge. Did Kentucky sophomore Eric Manuel cheat on his college entrance exam? Manuel has been temporarily withdrawn from the team. Charge. Did Kentucky offer recruit Sean Higgins money, cars, house payments? After a recruiting battle, Higgins emerged at Michigan.
Eddie Sutton.
Under Coach Sutton, the Cats face a losing season for the first time in 60 years. Sutton described his season as a living hell, but he refused to be interviewed on the controversy.
Kentucky is special. And we accepted the job, and my 4 years here have been very good. I've enjoyed it. And hope that we can get through all of this and get back to better times.
The good times began to slip away when Rex Chapman, the Cats' boy king, quit school last spring. He and Sutton clashed, and a state mourned. Amid this chaos, the Kentucky faithful is bitterly divided, not to mention bewildered. The Cats get curiouser and curiouser. Kaywood Ledford has been the voice of Kentucky basketball for 36 years.
I'm sure they'll fight some of the charges. They're only 18. 18 is not that little, and some of them are very serious, but, you know, we have schools now with over 200.
I talk to a lot of coaches like you do. Privately, they'll sit down, and off the record, they'll say, well, you know, everybody does it. But then you turn and stick a microphone up in front, cheating is, it's grossly overstated. Not that many schools really do it. Hey, come on.
The burden has been particularly heavy on Kentucky guard Sean Sutton, the coach's son.
His favorite saying is, tough times go away, tough people don't. We really haven't gone from game to game without something else popping up off the court.
From the old, former Governor Happy Chandler, to the young at heart, everybody contemplates the golden days, which in Kentucky now seem so far away.
It's not fair, it's not decent. Hadn't been handled properly, and of course everybody gets in a thing like that, you get your in the ringer, you have to do the best you can to get it out, you know.
Joining me now is CBS Sports and Sports Illustrated's Curry Kirkpatrick. And Curry, you've been following this situation very closely. How do you see it all shaking out?
Well, James, I don't want to be a Nostradamus here, but I don't see any way Eddie Sutton can survive this mess. The perception in the Commonwealth is that he is a lame duck. I really believe that he, Dwayne Casey, the rest of his staff will either be fired or forced to resign in the spring at the end of the season, at which point President David Rozelle, the president of the University of Kentucky, can go before the NCAA Infractions Committee and say, look, we have cleansed our house, we have gotten rid of everybody involved in these charges, and therefore lighten the penalties. As for Sutton himself, it's interesting, James, that this week he admitted to an Arkansas reporter for the first time, I believe, that were he to do it over again, he would stay at Arkansas and never have come to Kentucky.
All right, well, Billy Packer is joining us down at courtside. Billy, given the nature of the allegations, do you think that Eddie Sutton and his coaching staff should have resigned?
Well, I preface my remarks, James, by saying I'm very biased in favor of coaches and players. Eddie Sutton has been a quality guy throughout the course of his time as a coach. He's coached at three different Division I schools, almost a quarter of a century at a time, and not one time has he been involved with any recruiting violations. And in this particular case of the 18 violations, he is not personally involved in any of those. I think the time in this country has come when we go back to the point where people are innocent until proven guilty. I'd like to see some loyalty factor come forward at the University of Kentucky, and I'd also like to see the NABC step forward for one of their own. Eddie's the past president of the NABC, and it's time we all start showing some loyalty in that respect. The man at this point is totally innocent, and I'd like to see him get at least a fair chance to move forward.
All right, Billy, thank you very much, and Curry Kirkpatrick. And without a doubt, this is, if not the biggest, one of the biggest issues in college basketball circles today. Will be followed closely. Keep in mind, the NCAA's Committee on Infractions will be meeting in April, at which time an announcement is expected. Well, we've got a second half of basketball action coming your way. Tim Brandt and Billy Packer will have the call of that action. I'm James Brown. Thank you for joining us on the College Basketball Report right after this message and a word from your local station.
I've tried it, now I believe it. Denerex Tingles tells me it's doing more. Head and shoulders, no tingle.
Both have dandruff medicine, but Denerex adds both an extra anti-itch medicine and conditioner, too.
Goodbye, head and shoulders. Hello, Denerex.
America's leading consumer products rating service says one battery, Megatron 34 from Interstate, tested best. It ran circles around better-known brands and won by a mile. Megatron 34 from Interstate. Ask for it.
You hear the thunder, thunder.
The call of the road.
You feel excitement.
Get off your Pontiac and ride.
Pontiac ride.
It's quick and to the point. It's about power and performance. A hot ride with hot new looks. The dramatic new Grand Am.
Get on your Pontiac.
We build excitement.
They rammed L.A. Now the Vikings are out to topple Mighty Joe and the Niners. An NFC playoff battle tomorrow on CBS Sports.
This is CBS.
When I think of great food, there's two places that come to mind first. My mom's Sunday afternoon meals and the deli at any Happy Mart. Once you've eaten the fried chicken and potato wedges at the Happy Mart, you'll know what Southern cooking really means. Then there's all those homemade salad sandwiches like ham, chicken, tuna fish, egg, and pimento cheese, all made fresh daily. So when I want a sub sandwich or just pick up a few last-minute grocery items, I always go to the Happy Mart. Unless, of course, Mom gets one of those Sunday dinners cooking.
Toyota Fun 89 is almost over. Dealers nationwide are reaching their goal.
And offering the biggest savings in Toyota Fun history.
Savings up to $704 on truck option packages.
Up to $1,050 on cars.
We got a big discount on the options, so I feel like we got more car for the same amount of money.
More car for the money.
On top of a great Toyota Fun deal.
Toyota Fun 89 won't last.
So hurry into your Toyota dealer now.
The Honeymooners, Saturdays at 6 on WYMT.
We're about to begin the second half. Louisville leading in this ball game, 50-35. Tim Brandt, Billy Packer, your impressions, Billy, of the first half?
Well, I thought that Kentucky did an excellent job early on. They wore down, they got into some foul trouble, but this is a great Louisville club, and their pressure and their great depth that they have with this ball club right now is causing a lot of problems for Kentucky.
Wildcats start the second half with a turnover. Let me take you through the first half very quickly. Kentucky surprises with a quick start, 9-3 lead. Wildcats had no turnovers at that point, but then the Cardinals turned up the heat. The 7-minute mark, they went on an 18-6 run. 9 turnovers for Kentucky. The key has been bench scoring. Cardinals substitutes have outscored Kentucky 16-0. This is Smith on the right side, and his shot won't go, but he's fouled.
And Tim, for the first time today, Kentucky shows man to man.
This is the statistic we were talking about. 9 turnovers for Kentucky, 18-6 run in there, and that, of course, is the bench scoring right here, 16-0 in favor of the Cardinals. The leading scorers in that first half, Miller had 16 for Kentucky, and Payne, who's really been in shooting slump, starts out strongly here today with 12 first half points.
and made them all from the foul line. Here's another guy that's a great free throw shooter, LeBradford Smith. Last year almost shot 90% from the foul line. Down a little bit this year so far from the line, but a great free thrower. And the kind of guy you want to be on that line a lot, because you know his ability to penetrate, that he's going to get there, particularly early in the game, late in the game.
Smith now has 7 points, 2 assists, and Sutton throws it away.
There's a case where Sean went up in the air, picked up his dribble. He knows it's his fault. Kind of pointed to his forehead, said, you know, that's all mine. Two turnovers in a hurry here for Kentucky.
That's 11 turnovers for the game for the Wildcats. 52-35 is our score, just underway in the second half. Williams left side, can't control it.
Great offensive set shown by Louis there with a double screen. They look for that lob pass early on and then get the double screen for the drive to the basket.
Man-to-man defense for the Cardinals. Sutton picks up his dribble, now has to get it over to Ellis. Ellis way out at the top of the key.
Man-to-man, nobody in the low post now.
Ellis with the shot for two, it won't go. The rebound, Kenny Payne.
Nervous Ellison running the floor well, but Ron Ellis runs the floor well, too, for a man his size.
Kentucky now in a man-to-man defense as well. We saw a lot of zone out of both teams. Ellison inside.
Oh, he got pushed. Curtis Ellison got pushed by LaRon Ellis, knocked him almost out underneath the basket. No call.
No foul call. This is Sutton. Has the shot, passes it up, and walks.
Exactly. He's got the look for the shot. We'll see the push on the last play. I think Kentucky's going to have to get out of this man-to-man. Now you see, it goes into Purvis Ellis. Now watch what happens. LaRon Ellis pushes him under the basket. No call made on the play.
Sutton's taking a lot of abuse, and I'm talking about Sean Sutton, because he hasn't been hitting his shots. That time he didn't even take it.
It's hard to shoot when you're not looking for the shot. And when it's done as an afterthought, very difficult to get a good motion.
Williams to Smith, they take it around the horn. And Louisville turns it over.
Great job by Mills. He anticipated that bounce pass coming in. Great man-to-man by Louisville.
They tighten things up on Miller. They know he's got that long-range hot hand.
Got to give
LaRon. He'll take it for three.
Had to let LaRon Ellis touch that ball one time inside.
Tough move by Hansen inside. Never had a chance. Kenny Payne with the rebound. Purvis Ellison.
Does he have some hands?
Williams.
What this man-to-man defense does for Kentucky, too, it's going to take a lot of energy to play Louisville man-to-man.
Nice pass to Hansen.
No, Purvis Ellison has not blocked a shot here today. This could break a big streak that he's got. He's only 12 away from setting the all-time Metro record held by Keith Lee.
That was Hansen's first bucket of the day. He averages 10 points.
Miller on a reach.
Miller, number four, his first team second.
That's Miller's first second team foul. 17-16 remaining in the ballgame. It's a 52-37 Cardinal lead.
That high post offense looking to rub off.
Smith and Miller really banging. Payne loses the handle. Smith underneath.
Boy, he's so quick and powerful.
And he's got good court sense.
He really does. He understands the game so much better this year than last year.
That's 9 points for Smith. Hansen dribbles into trouble.
Gotta go cross court. There it is.
Miller has the shot for three.
Anytime you're double teamed to that degree and everybody's overplaying on the strong side, if you go cross court, somebody's going to have a jumper.
What do they say? Two men on me, somebody's got to be free?
I like it. Tim, you always are. Always. I told you that in the car coming over here.
Payne for three. Sutton picks up his dribble, almost had to, gets it to Mills.
Mills is such a smart player. You know, he came back. He realized Sutton had picked up his dribble. I think Mills has got the total package as good as any freshman I've seen come on the scene in a while. I realize he's not playing on a real strong Kentucky team, but he's a quality player.
That's Payne's second personal, Billy. That's the first team foul for Louisville this half.
Well, you know, one thing that Benny Crum can look at the rest of the year, he never has to worry about foul trouble. With this type of depth and the rotations he has, it's got to be a great feeling for him.
Kimbrough and Payne go out for Louisville. Miller drives the lane. Tough shot. Smith. Rebound Mills. Mills is consistent. Has it batted away by Cornelius Holden. And it'll be Kentucky ball. So with 15:55 remaining in the ball game, the lead is 14.
Coming onto the floor, would you welcome, please?
If you're into high performance, you've got to get into one of these. The 89 Pontiac Bonneville.
Get off your Pontiac and ride it!
Bonneville is a sports sedan that moves like a ground-level flying machine. Big, fast, and powerful. Bonneville. Test one soon.
Get on your Pontiac!
Rebuild excitement!
Pontiac ride!
You're looking sharp. You're looking good. You've come so far, and we know how to make the most of who you are. Where the race is run, you're the champion. Gillette.
The Gillette Atra Plus system with the Lubra Smooth Strip for the best a man can get.
Every night while you're sleeping, UPS is maintaining its status as the only company that delivers overnight to every address coast to coast. And we guarantee it. With UPS Next Day Air. And because we're so efficient, we'll still do it for up to half what other companies charge. Which is guaranteed to cause our competition some sleepless nights. UPS, we run the tightest ship in the shipping business.
CBS Sports coverage of college basketball is sponsored by IBM. The people, products, and resources to help you find the right solution. Gillette and the Gillette Atra Plus shaving system. Gillette, the best a man can get. And by Pontiac, we build excitement.
One of Kentucky's most recognizable pieces of real estate, Churchill Downs, just down the road, the home of the Kentucky Derby. We're in Freedom Hall, where Louisville leads Kentucky 54-40 with 15:55 remaining in the ballgame. Kentucky in blue with the ball. This is Sutton to Miller.
Louisville matching up again in that zone.
Miller with 19 points is free for a three-pointer, and he hits it.
Now, Holden will learn when he's playing that matchup not to aggressively chase his man across the lane. That allowed Miller to be wide open on the cross-court pass.
That's the lead to 11. And they're going to call Chris Mills for a hold. Tim Brandt and Billy Packard, Freedom Hall. It's a sold-out Freedom Hall in Louisville, Kentucky. Wildcats surprised us with a quick start, led Louisville 9-3, but then the Wildcats had 7 turnovers and ended with 9 in the first half. Louisville went on an 18-6 run, and they've controlled this game ever since.
Well, Eddie Sutton came out and did not hold the ball. There was a good piece of scouting. That is Louisville's out-of-bounds play. Derek Miller knew it from the scouting report, snuck around behind. Denny Crum, I'm sure, will be upset with his players for not setting a better screen.
Make note of this. Mills now has 4 personals. This is Williams, top of the key.
And Feldhaus came in for him, so he's sitting on the bench. Nice pass.
Charge, no walk. Walk on Holden.
Here you see a Louisville out-of-bounds play they've been using for years. 3 guys stand in a row, man jumps back. Miller says, hey, I know the play better than you do. He steps out there and almost picks it off.
Sutton, nice pass inside to Ellis.
Oh, Purvis got
He's
that.
He's fouled by Ellison. Oh, what a pass, Billy.
Great look by Sean Sutton. And an incredible reaction by Purvis Ellison to get a piece of this. Look at how far he's out of the play. He comes in here. I think it was a good block. No, he got a piece of the arm.
That's Ellison's 3rd personal foul.
And he still, Tim, does not have a block today.
So LaRon Ellis goes to the line. He's a 72% free throw shooter. And he misses the first one. California Player of the Year 1987 from Mater Dei High School. Water polo player.
Yeah, I saw that. Said he played in the hole. I guess he didn't have to swim. He could touch the bottom.
That's the 2-minute meter man, and no, he doesn't touch the bottom. That's the toughest position. A lot of whistles inside.
Well, his dad was into coaching last year at Southern Cal with George Raveling. Now, according to LaRon, he's back. Leroy is back in the real estate business.
Kentucky lost it out of bounds. Another turnover for the Wildcats. This is Williams, top of the key for the Cardinals.
And they stay man-to-man. Time for Purvis Ellison to get something down low.
Ellison are banging down low. Here's the pass inside, and the foul will be on LaRon Ellison.
You can see Louisville wanting to get him that ball down in the low post. Now watch this. LaRon Ellis doing a good job fighting over the top. Then what happens? Purvis will pin him. The ball is rotated. He's in perfect position. LaRon Ellis does a great job trying to fight back over the top, but can't get there.
That's Ellis's third personal foul. This foul on Reggie Hansen. And that's four on Hansen.
Tim, Eddie Sutton has no alternative but to go zone. His team is piling up fouls. He has no bench. And what you see right now is Louisville's going inside on him.
Four personal fouls on Hansen, four on Chris Mills, and three on Ellis. This is Cornelius Holden at the line. And he rattles it in.
Crenshaw High School graduate from L.A. Actually, I guess he's the first player Denny Crum has recruited out of L.A. since he left UCLA.
And he rattles the second one in. He's only 18 years old. He's the youngest of five Holden children, and that'll make it competitive. The Bears move on, eliminating Philadelphia. And Cincinnati, led by Boomer Esiason, leads by three touchdowns.
How don't you like the hats the guys were wearing on the NFL today? Somebody said to me, Butkus's hat looked like a cork on top of a bottle.
I saw your hat last week.
He didn't say that to his face.
Your hat last week was no day at the beach.
Scott Oatman, he's got a look to go to the hoop.
Instead, goes way outside to Miller. Miller doesn't have a shot. Scott now takes it, and he's fouled from behind. That's LeBradford Bishop, or LeBradford Smith.
Now, Scott showed some strength in his hands right there. That's LeBradford's third, but it won't make much difference because Denny can merely reload at the guard spot.
Williams will go out of the ball game. Denny Crum will come back with Kimbrough. So Kimbrough comes back in. So right now, Smith goes out. Kimbrough comes in. It's Kimbrough, Sullivan, Ellison, Brewer, and Holden.
And what that does, and it's the first time we're going to get the chance to see it today, it moves Sullivan back into the back court. And he'll be going back there with Brewer. So actually, we have a freshman back court lineup for Louisville.
Scott hits them both. And the lead's cut back to 11.
Show you what a ball handler Sullivan is right here. You know, you think of a guy this size coming into college ball being strictly a swing man. He can play any one of three positions.
That foul is on Miller. That's his second. This is what we were telling you. Reggie Hansen with four. Chris Mills with four. LaRon Ellis with three. Now Miller also has two.
Well, Eddie Sutton has always been a man-to-man coach. He's gone strictly man-to-man here in the second half. But the fouls are piling up.
This one is on Scott.
And they're quality calls. Now Scott with his third. And you see Eddie walking down the sidelines. His only alternative is to go zone.
Don't forget, tomorrow on CBS Sports, the NFC playoffs continue. The Vikings against the 49ers. It all starts with the NFL today at 3:30 Eastern time, right here on CBS. Kentucky's on an 8-2 run, but as we mentioned, some serious foul problems.
Well, they've got it down to 11 with Purvis on that line. You know, against Duke the first game of the year, it was 43-all until LaRon Ellis got into foul trouble, and by the time he got back in there, this game was 56-43, so you can see how little depth Eddie Sutton has to work with.
Sullivan, Kimbrough, Ellison, Brewer, and now Spencer in the ballgame for Louisville. 58-45. This is Deron Feldhaus to Ellis. Ellis better get it across the timeline.
He's doing a nice job. Handles the ball well.
Feldhaus had the shot, didn't take it.
Not looking for the shot. He's got to look for that kind of a wide open opportunity.
Miller will shoot it. Rebound Louisville. Outlet to Brewer. Here they go. The Cardinals. To Ellison on the baseline. Nice pass to Sullivan with the jump hook. His shot won't go.
What you have is a very inexperienced club on the floor right now, and a guy like Feldhaus is just trying to stay up with the pace of the game, so you can't really fault him for not looking for the shot. He just hasn't been in these type of situations very often.
Whistle away from the ball, and this is going to be called on Felton Spencer, the 7-foot junior. That's his second.
Is on Spencer, number 15.
Felton trying to get over there, working on Ellis. Just holding his ground, tries to fight over the top a little bit. Now he gets his arm caught in there, and that's where he picks up the foul.
Keep in mind, he's 250 pounds. Ellis is only 220.
That was a big three opportunity. Nice job by Scott.
Scott's in there battling. No foul call. Kentucky bench goes crazy. Two on one.
Well, he has some talent. Speaking of Sullivan.
Kimbrough for three.
Hey, Louisville right now not playing their game. They are in a position to go for the kill, and they're trying to rush it.
The foul was on Brewer. Now Kenny Payne comes back in, and Kimbrough goes out for Louisville as they continue to shuffle lineups.
And they kind of get out of the press a little bit here, picking up full court man-to-man.
Cardinals now have six turnovers.
They've had a lot of success double-teaming Miller. Let's see if they try it now.
Miller all the way himself. Kentucky just can't get the ball to drop. Ball's loose, no foul. Sullivan chases it down. Nice pass to Brewer.
He is so good. Last year was one of the great years for seniors in high school around the nation. Sullivan was considered a top-notch recruit, but not one of the key guys. But there aren't going to be many better ones this year in the freshman class.
Sutton to Ellis. And he's fouled by Spencer. Freedom Hall is rocking. The lead is 15 with 11:59 remaining in the ballgame. The Cardinals, six wins in a row. And they're leading Kentucky here big. We'll be back.
Meet Pamela, who's been hearing impaired since birth. Today, her world is changing with the aid of an IBM computer.
Ooh,
These may look like games to you, but they're actually part of an innovative system developed by IBM researchers to help people with hearing and speech impairments develop their vocal skills.
Motor gecko, motor gecko, bat. Eagle is a bear.
This system, called Speech Viewer, is one more example of how the people at IBM put technology to work. Not only in business, but in life.
My name is Pamela.
Bring on the city. Bring on the night. Bring on the highway. Clear out of sight.
The 89 Grand Am is restyled, revved up, and ready to ride. Try one on for size. It puts sheer driving excitement right at your fingertips. The hot new Pontiac Grand Am.
Get on your Pontiac.
We build excitement.
Monday.
I find your ex-husband extremely attractive.
Norman's got a classy new girlfriend.
That's my teacher.
And gets a lesson in love on Almost Grown Monday.
Here we're going to see that double team in the corner. LeBradford Smith and Tony Kimbrough have Hanson in the corner. You can count faces. Here's two other Louisville players. It means that somebody's got to be open cross-court. And watch what Hanson does very nicely.
Two men on me, somebody's got to be free.
And there he is. Case. Right. Timmy, I love that poetry. And the way Miller's shooting that jumper, it is poetry in motion. Here's Sean.
Sutton for three. Throws up a brick, rattles off the back of the rim. This is Brewer now for Louisville.
Kentucky does go zone.
Brewer's shot is short. Sullivan follows, and he hits.
Tough lockout situation for Kentucky in that zone. Sullivan doing a good job filling the hole.
Bellhouse, nice pass out to Sutton. They've got a three-on-one if they can convert it. Inside to Scott, and he's fouled.
Felton Spencer is doing some cremating in there. You know, Spencer
is
Spencer and LaRon Ellis were the two big men that the United States took to the Jones Cup and won the gold medal in the Jones Cup last summer. It's really the only gold medal the United States has won in basketball in the men's division in over 2 years.
That fourth personal gets Denny Crum's attention, so Kimbrough replaces him.
Now, he's a quality player. He's not in there to be a hatchet man, but he has just been cleaning house for the last couple of minutes.
Right now for Louisville, it's Sullivan, Brewer, Kimbrough, Payne, and Ellison. This is Sullivan.
Oh,
for three.
He can pass. He can shoot. He's got range. He can rebound. He can play multiple positions.
He now has 13 points. Derek Miller will fire. No, instead he passes inside to Scott. Sutton's open, and he hits this one.
And he looked for the shot as soon as he caught the ball.
That one's for two.
Watch Sean in practice. He's taken too many of those two-pointers right inside the three-point line. He's got to back up a little bit and get that three-pointer when it's available.
Nice pass to Ellison, and he's fouled.
Little two-man game, nothing for John Sutton to do other than foul. He got caught behind.
That basket will count.
You'll see right here, Scott does a good job switching off. Sean can do nothing other than push from behind. Probably should have left him alone.
Foul is on Sutton. That's his third. Ellison goes to the line.
We had Sean for three early in the ball game, so evidently he just did have two.
Nice rebound by Ellis.
Got to get rid of it. There's got to be somebody open here.
3-on-1 situation.
Oh, great.
Miller takes it himself.
And what made that so great is he was going up against the nation's top shot blocker and still pulled it off.
17-point lead for the Cardinals.
Kentucky goes back to man-to-man.
Tough pass inside. Sutton steals it for Kentucky.
Somebody open.
Again, it's Miller. Nice move. Miller now has 26 points.
Denny Crum is going to get annoyed with his club. They can't stand prosperity here. They get a nice lead, and then they get a little careless.
10 minutes exactly remaining in the ballgame.
Purvis Ellison wants it.
Ellison with the turnaround, and he scores.
What Purvis is doing right now is he's sealing Scott off, just waiting for the ball to be rotated.
Ellison has 12 points. The Cardinals come again with the press. LaRon Ellis to Miller. And Miller scores and is fouled. He now has 28 points.
He is filling it up. I mean, it's really nice to see. Last year, he'd come off the bench, as you know, six seniors in Kentucky, so he really didn't have a spot to play. He'd come off the bench as kind of like the automatic three-point man, and he just wasn't comfortable in that role. But today, he's aggressively taking the ball offensively to the basket, shooting well from the outside, and doing a great job.
Chris Mills comes back into the ball game. He's got four personals. And Scott will come out.
You know, when you think of this Kentucky club, of what might have been if Rex Chapman had stayed, if Sean Kemp had been eligible, if Eric Manuel would be on this squad, I mean, you'd be talking about a top 10 team there. That is not the case. These guys have fought their heart out today.
Ellison, his shot won't go. Rebound. Nice tip pass to Mills. Back to Ellis.
Exclamation point. This team's showing a lot of heart.
That was to relieve a little frustration.
Yep, they're showing a lot of heart. Outmanned, but showing a lot of heart.
Still 9-10 remaining in the ballgame, Billy, and it's 69-57. And that foul's going to be on Ellis.
4-on-0, fast break.
Is on Ellis, number 25.
You can see here, 4-on-0. You won't find that against the Louisville team very often. And the reason that it might have taken place is that on the floor at that time in the backcourt were two freshmen. And you talk about floor balance, and that's something that you learn only with experience.
Purvis, 13 points, 4 rebounds. Averaging almost 16 points a game. Ellis now with 4 personals.
And Eddie Sutton stays with that man-to-man. And that doesn't give him an opportunity to be protected at all, particularly when he's matched up against Curtis Ellison.
Ellis doesn't want to handle the ball. Fortunately for Kentucky, Kimbrough loses it out of bounds. Coming up on Monday, 1:30 Eastern time, it's the Mobile Cotton Bowl as the 8th-ranked Arkansas Razorbacks take on the 9th-ranked UCLA Bruins. College football Monday right here on CBS in Dallas. Ellis with a power move, and he's fouled.
Even with four fouls, he's being aggressive on the inside. You know, Purvis Ellison said something interesting yesterday when he talking about this year's club. He said, we want to win this game. That's his fourth. He said, we want to win this game so we can be undefeated in December. You always think about Denny Crum's clubs being undefeated in the month of March, and certainly February, where he has over 80% wins. The two games that they did lose, however, were in the month of November, so they do have that chance to be undefeated for December.
The 6'10 sophomore misses his first one. He's a 72% free throw shooter, and he makes the second one.
And when you think of Denny Crum, is 9-9 in opening games since he's been at Louisville. 50% record.
13-point Louisville lead, 8:35 remaining in the ballgame.
Three-pointer.
Sullivan. Strong rebound by Purvis Ellison, and he hits for two.
He was quiet in the first half, spent a lot of time on the bench, but he's coming on strong now.
16 points for Ellison. Chris Mills breaks the press, now has the ball batted away.
No place to go.
And Ellison loses it out of bounds. It'll be Kentucky basketball.
I mentioned before how smart it looks like the official got hit in the eye with that pass. How smart Mills is as a player. He's been coming back to meet the ball against that press well every time.
Don Rutledge, the official, was telling us before the ball game how quick he was. Well, he got in the way that time, and he may be a little bit shaken up. Of course, he was joking, I think, when he said how quick he was.
He said he'd like to hear the sneakers squeak. I said, if you do that one more time, we'll be carrying you out of here.
Kenny Payne will now come on for Louisville. Reggie Hansen comes back in for Kentucky.
And when you look on the floor, Tim, for Kentucky is that original starting lineup. They put in a lot of grueling minutes today.
Hansen over to Miller.
Defense really swarming now, matching up out of that zone.
Nice pass into Ellis.
Who oh, great pump. Shot!
Bucket!
Super play! Ellis.
The reverse layup by Ellis.
He pumped that and stayed in the air, went the other side of the hoop.
That cuts the lead to 13 with 7:49 remaining. Keith Williams
been
working
quiet.
On Sutton.
Williams has been quiet today. Kentucky showing again that aggressive man-to-man.
Nice pass inside to Smith, but he throws it away. Yes.
This is going to be one of the real gifted shots of the day. He goes up against great shot blockers, extends all the way out, puts the ball out there, and gets it off. Great play.
CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball will continue after this message and a word from your local station.
This is CBS.
Have you ever been upset by a notice from your bank? It says you're overdrawn or past due, or maybe you don't understand quite what it says. And even more upsetting is the bank's indifference when you ask for help. Take it from Gatewood. You deserve better than that. And that's why at First Commonwealth, we work so hard to help solve your problems and answer your questions in a fast, friendly way. A way that leaves you feeling good about us. We treat you like you like to be treated at First Commonwealth Bank.
Hey, what do you say there, buddy? It's me, AJ. You know, some years ago, somebody had the bright idea of having UK play Louisville to find out who rules the state in basketball. Now, some folks call it the dream game, but for me, it's become an annual nightmare. My first love are the Cats, but I root for the Cards, too. Of course, then, deep down inside beats a heart of true blue. Well, this year, I'm taking the advice of the folks at Quick Mart, and I'm going to be a Kentucky fan from head to toe. So no matter who wins, Kentucky wins. Go blue or red.
I Love Lucy, Saturdays at 6:30 on WYMT.
Electronics. From sharp minds come sharp products. Coors Light, there's no slowing down with a silver bullet. It's the right beer now.
and buy the new generation of Oldsmobile. Step into the future now at your Oldsmobile dealer.
A sold-out Freedom Hall is enjoying Louisville's performance here this afternoon, leading Kentucky by 13 with 7:29 remaining in the ballgame. In the first half, Louisville forced 9 Kentucky turnovers, opened up a 17-point lead. Kentucky's turned the ball over 13 times now for the game. Ellison with 16 points. Miller for Kentucky, 29 points. Ellis, only 7. But the lead's only 13 with 7:30 left. And I'm not saying Kentucky's coming back, but I think a lot of people didn't even expect it to be that close.
Well, I'm one of them.
And I'm the other.
I can tell you that. I thought that based on previous performances, you're looking at maybe a 30-point blowout.
Really no question in the difference in talent between these two clubs. The youngest team that Eddie Sutton's ever had, as Mills with a turnaround can't get it to fall. Adler passed to Williams. Here comes Louisville. Nice pump fake by Williams.
You know, what LeBradford Smith is able to do is explode and then come to a quick stop, and that's why it's hard to draw the charge against him.
Hansen goes over to Miller. He'll fire from anywhere, and that one's for three.
Is he gaining some confidence today? You can look at this club today as opposed to the club, although it was the same kids that played against Indiana, and you can see their confidence level, their aggressiveness way up.
Well, Miller had a game like this earlier in the year. He had 7 of 8 three-pointers against Cal. He's got 5 three-pointers this afternoon for 32 points.
I think he's doing more in shooting, though, Tim. You know, he's aggressive with his offensive play. He looks like the go-to guy. He's having trouble with his ball handling, but surely has to lift this club a little bit to see what he might do in the future.
Kenny Payne gets away with a push-off on Sutton.
Good switch by Sean Sutton. Louisville gets back into their rub-off offense.
Kimbrough over top of Mills. Air ball. Follow-up foul. The foul's on Derek Miller, and Smith will go to the line. That's the third foul on Miller.
The foul is on Miller, number 4.
Here's a case where LeBradford Smith, who is a great leaper, goes inside. He's been staying back for floor balance, but he also can be an explosive rebounder on the inside. Miller just couldn't keep him off.
He's jumping like that with a sprained ankle. Sprained his ankle last week in practice, has it heavily taped here today, but he wasn't limping much in practice yesterday when we saw him, or today.
Well, we talked about some of the track stats in regard to this Louisville club. The Bradford Smith high jump 6'10 in high school.
I can't relate to that.
Getting off the floor when it's your secondary sport, or even third in his case, but he's Hansen also a baseball player.
Hansen had the shot till he didn't take it. Sutton has a shot, and you know Miller will take it if he has an inch.
Now, Sutton probably had a better shot because Kimbrough was aware of Miller. Good rebound.
Kenny Payne with a fall away jumper for 2.
Have you seen a better follow through on a jump shot than Kenny Payne's?
Just like picking a peach, isn't it?
There's
a hand out there. 5 minutes and 20 seconds remain in the ball game. 79-63 Louisville.
Miller is a guy that has to be at the end of all passes. He has a very difficult time making a play.
Eddie Sutton wants a timeout. We'll take one as well.
Arkansas, UCLA, the Mobile Cotton Bowl, January 2nd.
My son Tom got a front-wheel drive Cutlass Supreme SL with FE3 suspension because tests prove that the new T-Bird LX and Cougar LS couldn't handle a curve this fast.
And Tom just loves those sharp, tough curves.
This is not your father's Oldsmobile.
How'd you like that fastball, Dad?
This is the new generation of
Oldsmobile curves.
Today, more and more people are drinking light beer. And the light beer they're drinking more of is Coors Light. Why? It's easy drinking. Got just the right balance of smoothness and drinkability. And best of all, the Silver Bullet won't slow you down. Coors Light, the Silver Bullet. For all the right reasons, it's the right beer now.
When I say sharp.
Copiers.
When I say sharp.
Computers.
Sharp. When I say sharp, I mean...
Calculators.
I mean...
Fax machines.
I mean...
Typewriters.
I mean business. When I say sharp, I mean business.
From sharp minds come sharp products.
When I say sharp, I mean business.
Here's a play that Louisville uses against that big pressure by Kentucky. It's called lead guard. They get LeBradford Smith out of the way with two solid screeners. Now watch, the screeners will go over and set the screen for Williams, who then brings the ball all the way around here for his layup. He can't get the lob. Here go the solid screens. Here comes Williams off, going on in for the layup. Excellent play, lead guard by Louisville.
Cardinals bring it in with 5:15 remaining in the ball game. You see the lead. This is Payne. Beautiful. Nice bounce pass to Ellison.
Beautiful job. Set play. And as we watched yesterday in practice, Tim, Louisville runs more dummy offense. That's offense without defense against them, half court, than any team I know of in basketball. And they have so many different sets. And almost any time they go to a timeout, they'll come out and there'll be a set situation. And that was perfectly executed.
Mills is fouled by Williams. And another reminder that tomorrow on CBS, the NFC playoffs continue. The Vikings against the 49ers. That all starts on the NFL today at 3:30 Eastern time. Kentucky now 14 turnovers, Louisville 8, and there's timeout on the floor.
Here's why these New England fishermen take Alka-Seltzer Plus cold medicine.
I get aches and pains, runny nose, nasally, and Alka-Seltzer Plus works every time.
When I get a cold, my head feels like it's 3 feet thick. Alka-Seltzer Plus helps break through, helps me get back on my feet.
Alka-Seltzer Plus cold medicine, fast, effective relief for tough winter colds.
In a word, it works.
Try Alka-Seltzer Plus nighttime cold medicine to relieve your cold at night.
My son Icky got the Cutlass Supreme SL because it has front wheel drive, FE3 suspension, and because tests proved that the new T-Bird LX and Cougar LS just couldn't run the slalom as fast. That kid, he's got all the moves.
This is not your father's old.
I learned it from you, Mom.
Got your cotton, your poly's got your permanent press. Got the right beer now to get us through this mess. Having some fun while it's going around. The silver bullet won't slow you down. So come on into Coors Light, it's the right beer now.
When you're having fun, the last thing you want to do is slow it down. So come on into Coors Light, the great light beer for a good long time.
L.A. Now the Vikings are out to topple Mighty Joe and the Niners. An NFC playoff battle tomorrow on CBS Sports.
4:52 remaining in the ballgame, and it's a big Louisville lead. And I guess if you have to point to anything specific, you'd say the bench scoring has been really strong for Louisville, outscoring Kentucky's bench 25-3, Billy.
I think they're going to outscore a lot of people off that bench this year, Tim. It is really explosive. It comes off. It's so flexible. Every guy is a quality basketball player. Denny Crum can go deep down to 10 men, and it'll be hard to play against them.
Billy, have you seen a stronger Louisville ball club?
Now, I mentioned that at halftime. In my opinion, at this stage of the year, this club is playing a lot better, obviously, than the team that won the championship, the last club that he had that won in Dallas. I'd say it certainly is a better club than the club that won in Indianapolis. Maybe the club he took in 75 to the Final Four had as much experience, but this certainly could be his best team.
Mills misses his second one. There again is another factor in the lopsided score. Louisville 24-27 from the free throw line. Kentucky not nearly as effective, 12-16.
Good steal by Hansen.
Hansen has a 2-on-2 over to Miller. Nice jump stop by Miller.
Oh, nice.
And a great tip by Chris Mills. Mills now 11 points, 8 rebounds.
There's a double team in time. I tell you, Eddie Sutton is pulling out all stops in this game.
Ellison got away with a walk. Spencer with the dunk.
That wasn't pretty, but because there was the double team way down court by LaRon Ellis, there was nobody back to defend.
4 minutes exactly remaining in the ball game.
Tough job here with the two big guys in the game for Louisville. A situation they haven't used much today really helped Purvis Ellison, because Spencer can do all the banging around. Ellison can be back there to block shots.
Mills' shot is strong. Rebound by Smith. And Mills knocks it out of bounds. Mills, perhaps the most consistent player throughout the year for this Kentucky Balls Club. And you're right, they all continue to fight, including Eddie Sutton, who is really intense over on the Kentucky bench.
Considering everything that's happened to this program, I'd say this is a tremendous effort on their part. They haven't folded up a bit.
Spencer knocks it out of bounds. It'll be Kentucky basketball. Hanson drives left side. He scores and he's fouled.
I believe that's all for Felton Spencer. And if you can get him in the open court area, he's just not back to be able to do anything defensively. Watch how his feet get crossed here defensively. There's when his feet got crossed and he was beaten.
That is five on Spencer. He leaves with 6 points. You see the foul again. Spencer sits down with 6 points, and Kimbrough comes back into the ball game for Louisville. Hanson at the line. And he converts the three-point play. He now has 9 points.
And look at Kentucky in a double-team trap of their own. Miller on the foul, but Kentucky aggressively going after him.
That's four on Miller.
The foul is on Miller, number four, his fourth.
Miller smiling out there. Savannah, Georgia, a young man, led his team to the Class A state championship, which is obviously not the highest classification in that state.
Well, personally, Billy, he's got a lot to be proud of today. 32 points, 5 from 3-point range, his season high is 36.
I think when you talk about highs, Purvis Ellison, high, he's never had a 30-point game. 27 is his high for his career, and what did he have, 24 in that national championship game. Again, Mills showing good smarts that time. Faking the pass, trying to see which way the zone was going.
This is Miller. Pass into Ellis. Ellis has trouble coming back in. He likes to spin to the baseline. Every time he goes inside that way, he gets in trouble.
Jerry Jones talked about that yesterday in regard to his...
Ellison with the slam.
Good on the inside. What we had the stoppage for right here, he hits 20 points. Now he had a stoppage because Tony Kimbrough had something in his eye.
'87-'69 Louisville. Miller hits again for two.
Now, one of the things when Denny Crum looks at this film, he's going to have to see that that press was not effective when people were able to go over the top and get that open jumper.
The left-handed Williams whips it over to Payne. And with 2:30 left in the ballgame, Louisville now just taking its time, melting the clock inside to Ellison. And the foul's on Ellis.
And what Purvis is doing is just pinning him, and Louisville taking top shots by rotating the ball and hitting him on the weak side. That's the end for Leron Ellis, a real nice class move by LeBradford Smith, congratulating him on the way out.
Ellis leaves with 7 points and five rebounds. Way below his 20-point average.
Those stats really don't tell the story of how hard he played today. His effort was excellent.
So Purvis Ellison goes to the line. Ellison averages 16 points a game. He has 20 today with 6 rebounds. So I guess you'd have to say Ellison won the battle over Ellis. Offensive goaltending, that one won't go. He hit it in the cylinder. They'll disqualify that basket.
Tim, you know, when you talk about this team compared to other teams, that 86 club with Billy Thompson and Milt Wagner and Purvis and Crook and Hall, they averaged between 6'4 and 6'9 in height, and as a team averaged scoring between 10-3 and 14-9 per game. That's basically the makeup of this club, that type of size, that type of balanced scoring. Tough to guard against them because they can score from so many different areas.
Miller's shot goes in and out.
About the only thing of drama left, will Purvis Ellison get a shot to block? He doesn't have one yet today, I don't believe.
But he's had one in 48 straight games. Payne scores and he's fouled.
Oh, my Payne.
tonight on CBS, it all starts with Dirty Dancing. Then it's Raising Miranda, followed by Simon & Simon. Then it's the CBS News Magazine West 57th as John Ferrugia talks with jazz musician extraordinaire Wynton Marsalis. That's at 10 o'clock Eastern Time. And Happy New Year, America, hosted by Gladys Knight, which airs after the late news. That's all coming up tonight here on CBS.
Tim, Happy New Year to you and
to
everybody
you,
else out there.
And all the best that goes with it.
And for those guys that started last night at 4:20 in the room next to us, I hope they don't have much of a new year tonight.
Did you get any sleep?
None.
Steal by Miller. Kentucky gets it back. 1:40 remaining in the ballgame. Hansen with a nice move. Tough move.
Hansen.
But they're showing me a lot of courage, this club.
That's 11 for Hansen.
They've got Georgia coming in, which is probably, Georgia probably playing better than anybody right now in the SEC. Tough test for them. This team has shown a lot of courage today.
Sullivan drops it off to Ellison. Cross-court pass to Williams for the layup.
Keith is, he's another great leaper. He can put his eyes right around that rim. A good pass by Purvis Ellison. Sees the court so well. There's the block. There it is.
And it brings the crowd to its feet. 49 consecutive games with a block. Smith.
Oh, my Smith, the assist for Williams.
Well, this may not be as sweet as Kentucky's win was here 2 years ago. But Louisville does get some semblance of revenge on these last few plays. Look out.
95. The crowd wants 100. Listen to them.
Well, there was a case where Bradford didn't give Chris Mills an opportunity to come down when he caught the ball. Tell some of those people to take a break. They've got a 22-point lead.
Williams sits down. Ellison sits down. And Smith sits down for Louisville. Freedom Hall is rocking, and that's why. It's 95-73 over the old nemesis, the University of Kentucky. 21 seconds remain. And since this series was renewed in 1983, Kentucky has pretty much dominated, winning 5 of the last 6.
Another thing for Purvis Ellison, nobody can ever say he never beat Kentucky.
3-on-1.
Oh, great play by Chris Mills. This shows some heart. Meant nothing other than pride, Tim. He just said, I guarantee I've had enough of that dunking in my face, and went up there just above everybody to steal it.
Number 11 is third in the game for Louisville, Shannon Fraley. Number 15, replacing.
I like this kid.
Number 21.
This is just a matter of pride. He said, no, no, I've had enough of that nonsense.
He's just a freshman.
Only by class rank.
He has to be placed in the same category with Alonzo Mourning, Chris Jackson, the best freshman in the country.
I would think so.
And that man continues to be in the eye of the storm at Kentucky, and Mills has the second shot coming. 10 seconds remain in the ballgame. It's 95-74, and they won't get 100 points as the crowd urges them on here this afternoon. Entire bench is emptied now. This is Sullivan. Drives the lane, dishes off Brewer for three. It won't drop, but the tip is good. That's the end of the game with the score. Louisville 95, Kentucky 77.
Odious, contemptible, deplorable. I'm speaking of offending in the personal grooming arena. Something I would, of course, consider quite beyond the pale. So I give you Rygard Sport Stick, antiperspirant and deodorant. When one needs to seek maximum protection and a fresh scent, one should grab oneself one of these Rygard Sport Sticks, because one would hate to be considered malodorous by one's chums. Now, wouldn't one? Rygard Sport Sticks from Gillette. Anything less would be uncivilized.
To
be successful in delivering packages to Europe, Canada, and Japan, it takes a lot more than fast trucks. It takes a knowledgeable worldwide staff, a computerized tracking system, and of course, a fleet of planes that fly there. Insist on all four. Worldwide service from Federal Express.
I'd rather switch than itch, so I switched to Tegrin.
Tegrin medicated shampoo controls all the major causes of itching and flaking, so Tegrin is more than strong enough for tough dandruff like yours.
Wouldn't you rather switch than itch?
America's leading consumer products rating service says one battery, Megatron 34 from Interstate, tested best. It ran circles around better-known brands and won by a mile. Megatron 34 from Interstate. Ask for it.
Derek Sullivan's last basket did come before the buzzer, so the final score was 97-75, Louisville over Kentucky. The Chevrolet players of the game, Derek Miller and Kenny Payne. Miller with 34 points, 5 three-pointers, 4 rebounds. Payne, 16 points, 5 rebounds and 2 assists. Chevrolet will donate a $1,000 scholarship to the general scholarship fund of each school to further assist qualified students in all chosen academic fields. Don't forget tomorrow, Minnesota and San Francisco as the NFC Championship Series. The playoffs continue in the NFL. NFL Today beginning at 3:30 Eastern Time. So for Billy Packer and James Brown, this is Tim Brandt saying so long from Freedom Hall with the final score once again, Louisville 97, Kentucky 75. CBS Sports coverage of NCAA basketball has been a presentation of CBS Sports, home of the NCAA Championship.